I don't even want to talk about that.
Shut up. You've been talking about it for 30 minutes. And
John,
I'm the guy
that doesn't talk about stuff. You talk about stuff.
Tell everybody that you send women pictures of you coming. Well, and John, you think that they like it.
John was very confident about his theories on what women want.
My theory is
women love
a woman
jizz.
Will take
what do women want?
A soft dick with cum picture. Over a hard dick.
You were so much fiery, like 5 minutes ago.
It's trying to capture lightning that was in a bottle that passed. The lightning's gone.
I think
John
it's still
was giving
there.
It lightning's gone. Speech. I'm just saying, like, you have to do something with your dick pics or your dick. You go, okay, dick pics, no more. Nut pics.
Yeah, you got to have
it's
more.
Nut
there needs to be bells and whistles with the
dick
pics.
Yeah, you
got to
have.
Now.
It's got to look like Christmas lights.
Yeah,
and shit
I put a little Burger King crown on mine.
I put
come through the top.
I put the Jack in the Box guy. You put on the antenna. Yeah. I put on the end of my cock and it shoots off
it's
when I
come. It's a fun time.
No, it's like you have to
non-cum dick pics are like
non-cum
so 2021.
Like, yeah, exactly. Yeah. No, not 1999.
It's like black and white.
Like, oh, you take a Polaroid? Yeah. Like,
it's the A-track player of
give
dick
them something, you know?
So they you're mean, saying hard cock is out, so you, soft cum is in.
No, I'm saying like if I think women would take like a half hard dick pics. Pretty dope.
Yeah.
When you know your dick's all swollen, it's not even fully like erect, but it's all swollen and meaty.
Yeah.
And then that covered with cum or cummy.
Yeah.
A girl would take that over a hard dick.
Okay.
That's just my theory.
Yeah, interesting. I heard that guys that are uncircumcised.
Yeah,
make women cum better. Is that true?
I think that's a cope for uncircumcised men.
There's something about the movement with their skin.
Uncircumcised guys made that up.
Uncircumcised guys are the Sith Lords of fucking dicks. Like they hide and they act like they're better than us.
Do they?
Yeah, they always do.
Everyone
when?
Knows that.
Everyone knows uncircumcised guys.
How?
Like,
where?
They just act like they're better than me.
You always do that, dude.
Dude, they're always fucking acting like they're better than me.
Yeah, they're always acting like they got something more. You know what I mean? Because they have a fucking onion ring around their cock still, and a piece of calamari still attached.
It is really weird.
Yeah, suck my ass, fucking weirdos.
I've never heard that about uncircumcised, that they're more confident. I always thought it was a lack of, they're self-conscious about
really?
It.
Really?
Yeah, no one has heard of this, what you're talking about.
I get a vibe.
John makes up his own rules.
Because also, I do. I'm a confident man. But I think uncircumcised guys, like, they're all European, which is just...
John will say things that you're like, I'm like, I don't, what? Yeah, he'll be like, dude, everyone knows black people, like, love horses. And you're like, do they? All right, I guess in your world.
I did have a long conversation with a woman who comes to my bar that's black, and we had a great... conversation of the differences between white and black people, and the main one I had was cleanliness. Mm. Black people are weird clean freaks about certain things sometimes.
Right. Socks on.
What?
They keep their socks on.
They either socks on. What did she do
I've noticed black people tend to hate seeing feet.
Yeah.
I like, really hate when white people wear flip flops.
Like, they say, like, get Joe Bunions out my face.
Yeah. That's every time they'd say that.
I feel
that.
Like every black household, like every night at one point, somebody in the house goes like, bunions.
I feel like they don't walk outside barefoot.
Get those corns out of here.
They don't walk outside barefoot.
Ashy bunions.
Yeah.
They don't walk outside barefoot.
They don't walk outside barefoot. One time I was at a laundromat and I saw a black dude Lysoling the inside of the washing machine before putting his clothes in there. And I thought that was oddly clean.
Interesting.
Yeah. And I was watching an episode of Bar Rescue where they went to Marshawn Lynch's like family's bar.
Well, first of all, I got to watch this ASAP.
Great.
Go on.
It's great. They go to Marshawn Lynch's family's bar. By the way, he's only 5'10".
Marshawn Lynch?
Blew my mind. I thought he was like an 8-foot giant for some reason.
No, he's just like powerful and compact.
They go to his family's bar, and like every episode of Bar Rescue, like John Taffert always goes in there and he's like, this kitchen's fucking filthy. Get the fuck out. I'm going to suck my cock. And then like
he runs. Is that what he says?
He's just like, suck it. John Taffert goes into the kitchen. Like they go to Marshawn Lynch's like bar, and you know, of course the fucking, you know, the bartender's like freestyling and like threatening to shoot customers and shit.
Is he?
No.
John goes, of course.
Of course.
John goes, of course, the bar is like in the back of an Escalade.
No, but they're like,
he's feeding his fish.
But they go. Fish. Not one word was spoken about the cleanliness of the bar, and I was like, I know that place is spotless.
Uh-huh.
I know that place is spotless.
You know, that's every episode of Bar Rescue. It's
always
a million
filthiest.
Complaints about how dirty.
Yeah, it's always like this Irish schlub who's running this place in New Orleans, and like there's like a fucking like giant fungus growing in the back.
Yeah, but, Tapper like runs his finger under the thing, and it's like all dusty. Yeah.
It's like 80. Yeah, it's that. But like this, they go into Marshawn Lynch's bar. They don't mention one thing about cleanliness. And I was like, I know that place is fucking spotless.
Yeah.
It's got to be clean as fuck.
I don't know.
I don't watch Bar Rescue.
It's fucking good. It's one of
the guy
best
I got in a fight with a few weeks ago outside of Red Lion. He thought it was a brag to yell at me. He goes like, hey, man, don't talk to me that way. I was on Bar Rescue. And I was like, well, that means your bar sucks.
Yeah, your bar blew.
Yeah, they only pick bars that are, like, terrible.
Yeah, he just said it like he won an award. I was like, you won an award for worst bar.
It also really threw everybody off because, like, there's, like, a verbal dispute going on. Devin's yelling at somebody. He's yelling at. And then he goes, like, I was on Bar Rescue. And everyone stopped and was like, why would you say
that? Even the people on his side were like, what are you talking about?
Don't say that in fights, man.
Jeez, that's a really bad thing to bring up in a fight.
I think he probably just panicked and was like, famous thing, I was on Bar Rescue.
Right, right.
You know, yeah.
Yeah.
Devin's
yeah.
legendary streak of getting into fights outside of Red Lion.
And inside of Red Lion.
Well, it was the what's the workaholics guy?
Blake Anderson.
Blake Anderson, we've already told it. That was the legendary one. And did you tell this already with this?
This last guy?
Yeah, we talked about it.
I think we did. Okay. Maybe a Patreon or something. I can't remember. But the Bar Rescue guy, that was the funnest. That was so fun. When somebody gives you gold like that,
I know.
When they're in a big fight and they go like, hey man, nobody talks to me that way. I was on Bar Rescue.
Yeah.
That's like being like, it's like being like, hey dude, nobody talks to me that way. I was on To Catch a Predator.
Devin has a way of forcing people to explain themselves in a way that I've never seen before. Like the barbecue pit. They're like, somehow they're trying to explain to us that they have a Michelin star and all this. It's like, why are you explaining yourself to Devin?
Why are you trying to win
you? Yeah,
trying to win this idiot over.
Did I convince?
Like, Devin doesn't work in the restaurant business.
Joey's covering the tab. He's not paying. I don't know why you're trying.
Just has an authority because he's a local or something. Yeah. Or he has like the energy of somebody like, I'm from here. Like, I know what I'm. He's so confident. They're just like, please.
I'm an LA townie.
Yeah, exactly. No.
I walk in like, you know, you better be doing things right in my town. I act like there's not like 30 million people living here.
But it works.
Yeah. And everyone moves here every day.
Yeah, Devin thinks the population of LA is 15,000 people.
Like, literally. I think I'm living in like Dorchester.
Except instead of like starting bar fights, you're just really snobby.
Yeah.
Because it's LA.
Did I convince that the barbecue place, Joey, that they don't have a Michelin star? I was like, no, you guys don't.
There's no way they have a fucking Michelin star.
No, yeah, you were basically just, you were sort of just like, sure.
No, the head. Yeah. No one believes that. The head chef was like a dishwasher at a Michelin star restaurant or something. Happened. That place has horrible food.
No, it was just like an Asian guy on a laptop, and the guy pointed at him and goes, he's got a Michelin star. And the guy, and the Asian guy was just sitting there just going like what is going on? And Devin just kept, ignored him, just kept on the attack.
I was really good that night. I was like, Michelin star. I mean, the food tastes like a Michelin tire.
Hey.
Very good.
And I got on the bar and danced. Everyone raised me up in the sky.
Yeah. We were chanting his name.
And chanting my name. They go, best joke ever.
No, we got to leave those people alone.
Dude, it's been excessive. We've been really dominating that place as of late. You brought a homeless man in. We talked about it, but you brought a homeless guy in.
He's hotboxed the place with a piss smell that I've never smelt before in my life.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as he sat down next to me, I was just like, I was like, I almost started puking.
It was he was smelling.
And then
the guy had been living on the streets.
Guy smelled like a bum.
Oh, so he was one of the piss smelled bums?
Yeah.
Because there's bums that smell like BO, and then there's
it was
bums
the strongest
smell like
piss smell
that
I've ever smelled.
Those are the worst ones.
It was like putrid.
And you guys were sitting at a booth with this man?
No,
we brought him in.
At the bar.
We were sitting at the bar.
Yeah. We brought him into the bar. We gave him shots. But we gave him some money.
I was like, he was so sweet, actually.
He was
though.
So nice, Alan.
I couldn't be like, you got to get out of here.
Alan was a great guy.
Devin loves remembering homeless guys' names.
Alan.
Devin. I remember when we were drunk in New Orleans, and this homeless dude who was just like, his name is Chicago. And Devin's like, no, his name's David. Like, Devin kept getting drunk and correcting me.
Well,
no, his name's Chicago. He kept referring himself to Chicago.
Chicago was his slave name, John.
Yeah, that's the name. That's his street name.
It's dehumanizing.
Honestly, no, bums should have cool street
Shame
names.
On you.
Shame on you.
There's a homeless guy in my town called Streetlight Charlie. I thought that was the coolest shit ever.
That is a cool name.
Yeah, I mean, his name is probably Charlie, but Streetlight Charlie is like, what the fuck?
Yeah. They always have like cool names.
Yeah.
They have great lives. But yeah, we brought this homeless guy in, and nobody kicked him out because they need the business. The homeless guy was like, "These wings suck."
He said that?
Yeah. No, we're kidding.
He's like, "Michelin star. I mean, it tastes like a Michelin tire." For fuck's sake, motherfucker.
We're like, "We say the same joke."
He's like, "Shit, it smells like piss in here."
Yeah.
Oh damn! Have you ever heard of an NBA player? His last name is McLeod.
Doug McLeod.
Another one.
I don't know.
Ernest? Something?
Why do you know him? What's going on?
He came to my bar today. He was like old. He was like in his like 60s.
Oh, he was an old NBA player. Yeah, I don't know. Could have been one. Back in the day, they were like playing. They were getting drafted in the war, coming back. Like they was.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were.
Yeah, he was like. He was like really. Over. He was like 6'9". And he was like an old black dude, but he just kept calling his friends bitch N-word and then challenging them to fights.
Oh.
And then drinking.
And he's at a train station like a vagrant. He's not.
No. He was with a guy, another guy, and he was like, it was crazy though. And it was just like three old black dudes just talking shit to each other. But one of them was an ex-NBA player who had face tattoos. I've never seen an old black guy with
old
face
dude
tattoos.
With face tattoos?
Yeah, old dude with face tattoos.
Wow.
Yeah, it was crazy.
People,
man,
I wish
you remembered what player was.
Yeah, people all tatted up with the face. Like, it's so common now. There's a guy at Joey's gym that comes in, and I'm like, I get visibly afraid when he walks in. I'm like, are we being taken over by like the MS-13? He's got like so many tattoos all over his face.
I've never seen him.
And he works out in like Vans. And he wears like a Juice WRLD shirt. Like he's one of those dudes.
There's some weird people in my building where it's like, yeah, there are. What race is he? Mexican?
He might be just like a white guy that looks Mexican because he got so many tattoos. I don't
know.
A lot
of white face tattoos.
Yeah, white guys are really into face tattoos now.
But he's probably like a famous rapper or something. Because how is he in that
probably.
Building?
I don't know. Everyone that lives there must be somebody kind of like.
Well, the rent is.
Alone.
At least the rent is like. It's like the cheapest rent, I think, is like $2,400 or something a month. Yeah,
yeah. But the face tattoos, it's horrific. Yeah. I feel like in like 20 years they'll be in like Dawn dish soap commercials, like the ducks from like Katrina. But it'll be like it'll be like that guy.
Yeah,
and you'll hear music. And they're like trying to scrub his fucking shitty ice cream
Dawn
cone
helps
off his face.
Dawn helps cover up your horrible decisions.
Yeah. Well,
yeah, whatever. Can't find him.
You know what? We were talking about sending, you know, dick pics to women and cum shots and whatnot. And you know what really gets women going?
What?
Is if you send them the Gringo Papi.
Oh,
you guys heard of that?
Shop's new Shop. Special.
Brendan Shop's new special.
Oh,
Gringo Papi. You didn't know it was called that?
No, I didn't know.
What's the
joke? I thought you were a
joke?
Self-respecting homeless cat.
I am a homeless cat.
Does he call himself the Gringo Papi?
It's the name of his special.
That's
I don't really
joke.
Know.
He's like, I'm the Gringo Papi.
It's just, it doesn't even make sense. He's not Mexican or anything. Well, what does Gringo mean again? It's like white guy?
White guy.
So he's a white, pop, white. Yeah. So the special is called The White Dad?
The White Daddy.
Papi means dad, right?
Well, I think the goof, because I am a homeless cat, I haven't been keeping up with it lately, but.
You've been clocking in at Chang's, right?
I haven't been lately. I've been taking a break at Chang's. But okay.
We're talking about the Fighter and the Kids subreddit, by the way. They have their own language. It's one of the most like well developed underworlds like ever. It's like Pangea or something.
It's fascinating.
Like, it's insane, but it makes me as like an MMA fan. They have some of the funniest Brendan Schaub jokes that I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah,
MMA fans have the like they'll do a million Tony Ferguson jokes, and every one of them is like, was this written by like George Carlin or something? At one point, they had there was a video where Brendan Schaub was on The Ultimate Fighter, the reality TV show, and Rampage Jackson was like just talking to him. And there's this clip, just like the homeless cats posted it or somebody posted it, and he just like gives Brendan Schaub just like a little like he goes, "What's that on your shirt?" And like just gives him a really light tap on the face.
Mm-hmm.
And the top comment was, "Can't believe that didn't knock him out."
I've never seen anything like that place.
It's amazing. They deserve their own wing at the Met Gala. I mean, Met Gallery. Galleries are.
They really do.
They're incredible.
They work hard. It's like they're making great content. They're editing like really good videos.
I've never seen devotion like it for anybody.
They don't miss anything.
They hate him so much.
It.
It's love at this point. Like they're like
they can't live without him.
They can't live without him.
Bees on honey.
Did you guys see this thing where he's like, he bullied Bobby Lee or something? Because
I started to watch that a little bit, but I'm out of the loop.
He acted like he acted like Bobby Lee was like running the subreddit and like shitting on him. Like he's like an OP on it or whatever.
This sounds made up.
Well, this whole thing
sounds. We talked about
made
it,
up.
Or he didn't talk about it, but they talked about it on this. Bobby Lee's girlfriend actually got him into trouble. Mm-hmm. Are we allowed to watch other podcasts?
Yeah,
highlight?
Yeah.
It's not like copyrighted, right?
You have to be able to. Yeah.
All right. This is that H3H3
talk about
podcast.
Brendan Schaub. But you're down.
No. So, Brendan Schaub?
Well, here's what I'll say.
No,
about
Brendan
Schaub.
Schwab.
Oh, God, Brendan Schwab. Yeah, insurance salesman. Yeah. Oh, come on, yeah.
I call him a Schwab because he looks like a Schwab. You know, like, is that they call those Schwabs?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're fucking Schwab? Hilarious.
Okay. Can people even talk? These people have like millions and millions of dollars and tons of podcasts, and no one even seems like literate.
I'm like on Schwab's side already.
Schwab speaks as well as this Ethan guy.
Yeah.
They're like, and Ethan, you know, wasn't punched in the head a bunch of times. What's his excuse?
Yeah.
At least Brendan Schaub's like the Aaron Hernandez of comedy.
I think Ethan actually has like a Tourette syndrome or something.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that blinking thing he does.
Yeah.
I don't know what his issue is.
So he does have it.
But at least Brendan, like, tries. I mean, he's just bad.
At least he's out there.
They both have brain issues.
At least he's out there doing the fucking Gringo Papi shit. He's got the thicc boy production company. They make songs and shit. They're like, I'm on the Fighter Man Cash. You heard that one?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck.
It's
at the end of his special. We already did. We watched this on the Patreon, but we're not gonna watch the whole thing, obviously. Right, this is how it starts. So this is.
I think it's the intro and outro song.
Yeah. Really trying to get it. I take the L and elevate. I push it past the limit. Don't need no diamonds on my wrist, though. God, because
the special is it's not like a Jimmy John's.
Thick boy squad. Thick boy nation.
How do I buy this?
You guys want to watch one joke?
Yeah. Are we allowed to?
I think.
Where's this fucking shot
at?
Wait, is this like a pirated thing?
It's on YouTube.
But did he release it?
Yeah.
Okay, I think it's fine. Yeah. I hope.
I don't know. We might get sued by Thick Boy Productions.
Risk it. And then if he sues us, we got a great war.
Who cares? Yeah. Big war going. And he's doing it at a club where there's, I guess, you know, like 40 people there.
Yeah. Yes. He's doing it at the fucking Peter Pan ride at fucking Disneyland.
I'm not used to this. Dallas a little different. There's some ladies in the crowd tonight.
Dude, shut
you're not
up,
used
dude.
To this.
Dude,
Dallas is different. The There's fuck. Women in the crowd. I mean,
oh my God.
What?
Dude. Suck a dick.
Who? Let's do a. I want to just know who these people are. Let's look at them. Let's study these people.
Zoom. Full screen then.
Who? Okay.
That's a
how
chip.
Did these?
He just thought that was a chip.
How did these two get into that?
They all make, but this makes perfect sense actually because you know like they have to pick the best looking people to make the front row.
Yeah,
that's Schaub's best looking fans. Yeah.
Really?
That has to be.
Wow.
That blonde in the corner there, she's got a unless you know her body just turns into that in the front that blob, but she looks skinny.
Who this
the blonde right there?
Oh right, yeah, they got better looking people. I don't know. These are just the,
but they were probably like, I don't want to be seen. I don't know who this is. I got tricked to like somebody just paid me to come
here.
Are
these people really like? You think they're fans, or are they just there?
God, yeah.
Somebody paid them.
I've never met
those two guys
a real fan of Schaub in
my life. A friend of mine worked at a comedy club in Tampa, and the way he made it seem, and I think it applies to Dallas, is like people just go. It's like the comedy
club. It's just
they
a
don't
thing.
Even know who they're seeing.
It's
the
just
time.
A revolving door
Some
of clowns.
People do.
They
just like put another clown up.
Yeah.
But there'll be a description of like who they are and their sort of style of comedy. For Brendan Schaub, would be like, oh, well, you know, Joe Rogan, all has his podcast.
They're also
people will just show up,
and they give tickets out for free. And Schaub's promotion company, they got busted by doing a thing where they said this is a homeless cats thing. They had a whole promotion.
Cite your source, the homeless cats.
They had a whole promotion, and this is actually proven. They did a big promotion. If you give 5 stars on Brendan Schaub's IMDb for his special, then you get the chance to win like this prize, basically.
Oh.
Which it's like incentivized traffic. It's fraud. That's like considered fraud. Any review site will consider that fraud, right? So, but the homeless cats got wind of this and it's the lowest rated thing in IMDb history because the cats came in.
The cats came in.
And what? Just a million one God, stars.
They're superheroes.
God, imagine having a fan base that just fucking hates you.
That's all they
it's
do.
It's wild.
But it's this is the punishment, okay? If you're grifting like he is, where you're not a comic, but you're just like getting in on this, like, you know, this era where Rogan, you can just make some money and have a bunch of podcasts, and it's a cash grab for him. So like, but if you do that, people are gonna, they have eyes, they're gonna be like, you suck though. Mm-hmm. And you're like, you kind of can't even speak well, and you're a liar and blah blah blah. Yeah. So we're gonna attack you, but yeah, go ahead, keep making your money. But that's the natural, it's like a natural repercussion, you know, like, yeah. He's done comedy for like 3 years. You know what I mean? Yeah, he's had two specials and he has tons of podcasts with, you know, people that are maybe a little aggressive in bed. And so they're on to that, and they're gonna go to your IMDb and they're gonna give you one star because they're, you know, hey, that's the only thing we can do. All us cats can do is come together and
maybe the cats will create
scratch away.
They'll code a bot with using a network of proxy IP addresses that are designed to do one star reviews in mass. Maybe you'll have the lowest rated IMDb of all time.
What else can you do? Yeah, simply in this situation. You have no other options.
You've left us with no other option, Chubb.
It's a small price to pay for how much money you have coming in for being like bad at what you do.
You back a homeless cat into the corner, they're scratching. You know, what do you expect to happen?
The homeless cats are feral.
Shloob, Brenda, what do you expect to happen? For Christ's sake, Brenda.
I mean, for Christ's sakes, Bapa.
Bapa.
God.
Poor Chubb.
Yeah. At least he, like, doesn't probably remember much, so he, like, doesn't.
Because of his CTE.
He probably wakes up every day, and he's like, I'm, like, the king of the internet, and he goes, he's like, oh, what's this, I forgot about this Reddit thing. He, like, probably forgets every day.
Yeah, it's Groundhog's Day.
It's Groundhog Day for
him. 50 first dates.
He's like,
50 first dates, yeah. Better
he wakes up every morning, Rogan and Callan are like, it's just make sure the right newspaper's out, so he's not freaking the fuck out.
Yeah, he has to write.
Yeah. Every day they give him the LA Times the day before the Callan allegations came out.
It's the LA Times.
He's like, looks nothing new here today.
Like he scratched his purple Porsche last night. We got to buff that out real quick before he wakes up.
Oh, fuck. So, okay, this is the crowd. I mean, look, that's this guy. It's like white guys that look like they're trying to be black by like if they curate their beard.
Those
well
two
enough.
Conservative Latinos on the right. Are
yeah,
for sure.
Conservative Latinos probably Latinos, love him. Yeah.
Those guys work at T-Mobile and they fucking.
Yeah, people at T-Mobile look like they party.
Dude, it's wild.
Yeah, right. Yeah. There's something about T-Mobile employees.
Yeah, they look like they go to Vegas every.
Yeah, I'm like
weekend.
You're buck wild. Like they look like they all do like poppers and E and all sorts.
They do.
Yeah,
I can tell as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They have to think about what their lives are like.
T-Mobile. Can't even work for Verizon like a real man. Everyone that works for Verizon thinks they're like an entrepreneur.
Yeah, they're like madmen.
People that
Verizon.
Work for Verizon, they're always like Armenian guys that like listen to Jay-Z and they like frame their bachelor's degree on their wall and shit. And they're like I'm just like Jay. Like I'm
right
like,
next to their Scarface poster.
They're like they wear they always wear a suit and
back
they're like
to the grind, bro.
Like, you're selling fucking androids. You're not an entrepreneur. All right, let's
see.
I'm used to that. My demo, 18 to 36 bros. That's what I specialize in.
It's kind of we won't watch the because we watched the whole special on the Patreon. By the way, check it out.
You did?
Me and Richie did
the whole
other night.
Thing.
We watched the whole thing.
It's only 25 minutes.
It's only 25 minutes. It's not a real special.
It?
Yeah, it's 25 minutes.
What?
Well, it's the best.
Oh.
He curated like the best bits.
Huh.
He cut out the fat. It's actually
he's a curator.
Genius. He cut out, you know. Okay. Enough of these long specials full of, you know, jokes that people have worked on. Just get out there and fucking dance around for a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Put out,
you know?
He wants to put his best foot forward.
So, I kind of want to just study the crowd here.
I don't mind it, though. I'm the bro whisperer. That's what they call me.
How is he not? Okay, like, how is he white, dude?
I have no idea. Yeah, I was saying this the other day.
We went over that,
Well, he's got fucking like, mind that guy's
he's
white.
Got like Easter Island face or something.
Well, he's been punched in the face so many times.
Yeah.
Dicey.
Has that worked on you?
I love you, Texas. That's how it is.
Hell yeah, Bapa.
I love it. There's always one guy. No fucking way, bro.
Oh, he's doing that.
I mean, I don't even know what's happening.
That needle's not touching this fucking temple, daddy. As he says,
I can't believe I'm watching this for a second time.
This is my fifth time watching it this week. I've literally shown everyone.
You have a mental illness.
Look at that still.
I watched it with Tim like three times. We're obsessed with it.
Oh, name drop to get out of it. Then you both have mental illness.
No, not Tim Dillon. Oh. Tim Jones, the guy that works at 7-Eleven. He loves it.
The homeless guy, too.
He's a homeless cat.
Yeah, whatever.
Imagine being at these jokes and you're in the back going like, woo!
like Chubb just doing like.
He's literally just prancing around, like peacocking and stuff.
Man, this whole vaccination stuff, I'm not anti-vax, man. I'm vaccinated, but it's all in their marketing. They fucked this whole thing up in their marketing. Without Operation Warp Speed, when they launched that, remember they're trying to get everybody to get vaccinated?
Hold on, guys.
Go to Krispy Kreme, buy a dozen donuts, get vaccinated. Like, the fuck? That makes sense. Fat people are like, hell yeah, fuck this.
That's good, because it's like, if you're fat, you like donuts.
I can't even listen. I'm taking my headphones off.
Joey, be a, come on. Come on.
Just give it two more minutes.
You need your catnip.
It's so confusing. I called my mom. I was like, hey, mama, are you getting vaccinated? She's all, I wasn't. And then, you know, I love donuts. And fucking,
hell yeah. Hell yeah.
I wish I could kick his ass.
I know. He's just so big.
That he would kill me.
He's so big. He seems fun to hang out with, like, you know.
Yeah.
Just on his own, like, you know, with him.
Maybe.
Right? Maybe?
Well, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, yeah. You know, the guy's ride or die.
Yeah.
Of course he is.
Fuck yeah, he is.
He'd let you get away with anything. You could, like, tell him you killed somebody. He'd be like, oh, you want to do a podcast? Like... You tell him you like murdered your family. He's like, you want to like join forces?
You know, you raped like five women in the 90s.
Yeah, let's like do a show called like The King and the Sting or whatever the fuck they do.
Everybody scared the shit out of from getting vaccinated. Remember that idiot? He's all over the news stations. The first moron to get that Johnson & Johnson. Clearly a meth addict. They just, nobody checked into his background. Remember that? They put him on the news. He's sweaty as shit. He was on all the major broadcasts. He's like, holy shit, dude!
Oh, he's
this is heating up, guys. Stop. Get off your phones.
He's going, I'm not on my fucking phone. I'm on mine, and I'm going to stay on it until this is off.
Hold on. We got one more crowd shot.
I love how he's doing
physical
comedy.
Joey's on his phone. He's on the Fighter and the Kid Reddit.
He's on the subreddit.
I mean, on your phone.
You're posting clips.
I'm posting clips on the subreddit.
God, you're a fucking devoted cat.
Yeah, I'm a cat. I'm all those cats.
You're clocking in at Chang's. Do what you got to do.
Thanks. No, I just got to make... I got to finish this post.
It's all in marketing, man. Like, they need to hire some just a dime piece actor we've never heard of. Just blast them all over the news, right? Just somebody who's fine. Get them on there.
Mm-hmm.
Just put them all over the news, all over the nation. Like, dude, I got the Johnson & Johnson. I feel pretty good. I feel great, actually. If I'm being honest, one side effect, I just want to be up front with everybody. Goddamn dicks.
He can't even speak.
Dude, like, seriously.
I mean,
he's not saying anything.
He's not saying anything,
but his tempo is like out of a joke.
That's how stupid comedy crowds are. Is that
wild.
You just hook them on a rhythm, and you could literally be up there going like, bah, 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 bah,
yeah, he's speaking like a sim.
Bah, 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 bah. And then people just laugh. They're all tired from work. Everyone's doped up on Coca-Cola and fucking taquitos and shit. And everyone's just shitting their pants and the brain dead.
Here.
I mean, look at these. They're like seals in the front row.
Get dick get big if you get vaccine.
His jokes are literally like that
dick
level.
Big. Imagine if your dick big.
Imagine you get the vaccine, you got a big dick. Then people are like, whoa, that'd be like a fun side effect.
Yeah.
They make a t-shirt where it's like a vaccine and then a huge cock and they sell a million.
Wouldn't it be funny if Brendan
had... They're at Target. Yeah. You know when you go to Wall t-shirts at Target, there's one of the big cock.
It's a syringe and a huge cock.
A syringe, a huge cock, and it says Gringo Papi on it. It's next to the McLovin ID t-shirt.
Look at this guy. Look at this foo. He right here.
That's a white boy.
Is that a white guy?
It could be a light-skinned.
He looks like a light-skinned.
It's hard to tell in Texas.
Yeah.
It's hard to tell in Texas.
This guy, I don't know. He loves queso.
Yeah.
It's good to be in Dallas, man.
No, it's not.
Right. It's good to be in Dallas. I know. Yeah.
Woo! I mean, I can't.
I can't believe shooting a special at this fucking place.
And it's 25 minutes long.
It's crazy.
That's insane.
It's like an episode of Rick and Morty.
It's a 25 minute comedy special. They're supposed to be an hour.
Oh. Hell yeah. Doing hell.
There's a reason I said I shoot my special here, man. You guys just give me so much love.
Because there's a reason I shoot my special here, guys. It's because my career is plummeting. Every day, I am on my way out, guys. There's a reason I'm here shooting this special at a Dave and Buster's.
In Texas, man. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I haven't touched a mask since I touched down. It is fantastic.
Look at this guy. Look at this.
Go full screen. I can't see.
This guy right here.
Oh, is that fucking...
He looks like the master. He looks like...
Is it It Man?
He looks like the guy that trained him to do... He trained him to do comedy. This is like Mr. Miyagi of Brendan Schaub. Look at him.
He's like, tell them about the big deal.
Why is this guy in the crowd? He's...
He goes, do that dance again now. He goes,
okay, prance across the big deku.
He goes, talk about the women in the crowd.
You haven't touched the mask.
He goes, okay, you haven't touched, it's time to go your segue into dating a room.
Tell them it's great to be here.
Mask on, mask off.
Say you like a Dallas a lot. You must say you have never seen a woman in crowd. It will be very funny.
I talk about the fat people with the virus. And they wanted the donut.
Okay, go into a talk about how the corona came from my people.
All right, keep it going, Dev.
You like this, John? You're into it?
That's great. I'm into it.
I'm back in.
We're doing a Schaub double feature.
Double feature, guys. What do you want out of us? It's 25 minutes.
You know why he looks Latino? Because I think he's had work done. He's been punched in the face a million times. He's got tan-ass skin. And he's fucking, you know what he does? He does his eyebrows. His eyebrows are like fucking plucked.
Threaded or
whatever. Yeah, like threaded or whatever.
Well, he's also brown. He's like got brown skin.
Yeah, that's the thing. He looks kind of, he looks like he's something.
He looks Mexican.
Yeah.
That's what he looks like.
Yeah.
It's crazy that he's white.
I mean, it's kind of crazy. Like, I honestly feel like Jake Lamotta, like, his comedy career was better than Brendan Schaub's.
It's a similar venue.
It's similar. Like, to the end of the Raging Bull. He's just looking at himself in the mirror here before the show. He's backstage.
He's super fat now.
Super
he's
fat, like, yeah.
He's remembering his career.
Lamotta was a bit of a thick boy, if you will.
Yeah, exactly. Raging Bull there. Yeah. The last half, like, the last 20 minutes, this is Jake Lamotta, like, trying to sell, like, thick boy clothing.
Yeah. He's like, what the fuck is this fucking Reddit? These fucking homeless cats.
I'm gonna fuck one of those.
Yo, coronavirus makes your fucking dick big.
So, nice to be here, Dallas. I usually don't do shows like this. You know, there's a lot of women here tonight. My shows are usually a sausage fest.
he's at the Copa.
Remember the vaccine? The first guy got it? That fucking guy? Huh? I mean, come on. Bad PR. You know, it's a PR problem.
Can you imagine being the first guy to get the J&J? He's like, I thought. He's like, it's nice to be here, Dicey. Good to see you, Papa.
What? Callan? What? She was 16? What are you talking about? I checked her ID.
He's like,
what are you talking about?
He's like, you're telling me Annie Letterman's a comic?
They're talking about locking us back down. I can't go through another lockdown. Straight up, the Schaub household barely made it through the last one. We eked our way out of that last one. We did not do well with it. Also, Dallas, my lockdown's different. I got a 5-year-old and 2-year-old. Parents know what I'm talking about. I would rather do anything else than be locked down with those fucking demons 24/7.
There we go. There
all
we
the
go.
Children demons.
He goes, I'm locked down, my girl.
He goes, Sugar Ray Robinson? He goes, love him. Never met him.
Joey's impression's amazing. He does the greatest De Niro face. Here, hold on. Let me try and find the last scene of Raging Bull when
he's in jail. And he's like punching the wall.
Can we play that?
If somebody else posted it.
All right.
I think you're allowed to do those Fandango.
These ones? These movie clips?
I don't know.
What the fuck is with this guy?
Let's not risk it.
Yeah, all right. Fuck
We've
it,
done
fuck
too
it.
Much.
Fighting with me the other week. We got locked down. We're fucked. She was fighting with me. Fucking like, Fauci, Delta, mass. What are we going to do? I'm myself. Oh my God.
I mean, she's fucking bitching at me. Fauci.
Just getting shit.
Mask. You know what you mean?
This is horrific.
You try to post on my Reddit.
He goes, Bobby Lee. You make a subreddit about
Bobby
me.
Bobby Lee, are you a homeless cat?
He goes, Bobby Lee. I linked an IP address.
Bobby Lee's like, what are you fucking talking about? You fucking fat fuck. You fucking sitting there like a fat fucking fuck. He goes, well, really? You a lot of people, you know, been talking. You know, they say you're a homeless cat. You been clocking in at Jenks?
He kicks the shit out of his brother.
He goes, punch me in the fucking face.
Just punch me right in the fucking face. Huh? Take a hit.
At the end of the special, he's like, never got me down, Dallas. Never got me down.
Gringo Papi.
If I was locked down with the bros, Dallas...
Okay, this is a good bit.
Okay, he has a good one?
Yeah, this is a good one.
Oh, okay.
You know how much more fun we would have? Oh my God, dude.
Do you think he like writes that? Like, it's a very well written special, obviously. Like, yeah. Like, so I can you know, he's probably got like, you know, you think he has like a notebook?
I'm guessing he has a million notebooks.
He has like a gel pen.
He probably has a
writes.
Ton.
You think he goes to coffee shops?
Yeah, he's got
like
a gel
writes.
Pen.
Gel pen. He's
like a sparkly gel pen. He's sitting there. He's writing it on the back of a bunch of subpoenas given to Brian Callen.
It's crayons on the back of a Callen subpoena.
Some guy's serving a paper. He's like, they keep giving me stationery at the coffee shop.
He's like, I do most of my writing at Chuck E. Cheese with Crystalia.
Like, play video games all day. We'd work out.
So this is his good joke.
Yeah, hold on. You're about to. He's about to drop the hammer.
I'm sorry.
We'd like play video games all day. We'd work out. At night we'd fuck each other.
Because they're gay.
That's good.
Because what? Gay. Well, that's the John.
But who?
Maybe it's a little. Okay. Maybe it's a little bit like subversive
me.
For yeah. you. A little irreverent comedy.
I need
John,
to be.
You didn't get that,
John.
You know what? That was a little bit. I mean.
Okay.
Have...
So do you think in his notebook he wrote like? At I'm gay in the joke, and then I'm hanging
out. That's how
out.
He started. He goes, first of all, I'm gay.
He goes, I'm gay.
And there's an arrow down.
There's an arrow. And he goes,
and
oh.
me and my boys, he goes, we're also gay.
Gay with who?
Gay
my
with
boys.
My boys. Then he goes down. He goes, in quarantine with my boys. and then he goes, what do, he goes, he's, he thought for a second, he's, he looks at his espresso at the coffee shop, and he goes, like, what do gay guys do? And he goes, they fuck each other. He goes, that's the punch. He goes, that's, okay, so that's the punch. If I hit that at the right timing, it's a home run. This is a home run bit.
He goes, I think I just did something that was genius.
Yeah. Me and my boys, if we were locked down together, we'd fuck each other in the ass.
He calls Chris D'Elia. He like tells him the bit, and Chris D'Elia's like, "Dude, can I use that?" Do you Chris D'Elia
impression?
Oh, Chris D'Elia.
So like,
unwraps.
You go over there, and then like they get out like.
Chris D'Elia peels a 13-year-old off his fucking face and then gets on the phone.
Dude, like, you're
he's like, oh, that's genius job. He's like, okay, get back on.
Real quick.
I saw that she was, like, wearing a training bra, and I'm like, she is perfect for me. She was getting out of the car like, whoa.
Chris D'Elia.
Dude, you, like, got to go.
He's like, dude, you know when like an underage girl like is going to school, dude? Like,
Chris Steele's on one of those, like, you know those cards you put quarters in at the mall and it moves back and forth. He's just catcalling 12-year-olds.
Yo, like,
he just hangs out outside of one of those with a roll of quarters. And
he's like, who wants a ride?
He goes, oh, look, your ride's over, isn't it? Well, I got another one. Yeah. He goes, you need another one.
And then I give him the quarter, I put it in like, cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
Fuck.
That's why I don't do college gigs, but I'd love to get some elementary school gigs, you know?
Chris Lee was doing elementary schools.
To fuck the girls. Because he's interested in the women.
Chris Lee, as he sold out a Montessori last week.
He's like, oh my God, like, you know when like your girlfriend like gives you a macaroni necklace and shit? And you're like, this like sucks. It like sucks, right? The thing about like drunk girls is that like you can't even get like the small ones drunk.
He's very close to Ramon.
It's like illegal. Yeah, he's very.
It's about one octave away from Ramon.
You know what's funny is that he's not allowed back at the Comedy Store, and like the Comedy Store like kind of sucks without him.
Yeah, they need
it. Comedy Store doesn't have, there's not an energy there anymore. They got to get to let these abusers back.
As Captain Jack said, it would be much better if they let the molesters back in.
Yeah. Captain Jack had the best.
Captain Jack
should run the Comedy Store.
He should.
They should make him the new manager.
Yeah, he should be the booker.
Yeah.
Dude, is Captain Jack watching my set? He stays in full.
He can't get out of it.
What if Johnny Depp starts running the Comedy Store after the trial? Like, he becomes the booker?
Yeah. That would be, I would love to see that happen.
That'd be great.
Yes.
And he's like, put up Geppetto. Geppetto's got a tight five.
He goes, Geppetto's got a tight five.
You put Geppetto up.
He goes, I'll stand at the back of the stage. I'll throw him grapes.
He goes, what's really the difference between any of these comics and an actual dancing monkey?
He goes, no, really. Think about it. What's the difference?
He goes, truly think about it.
Geppetto
he goes, if you get down to brass tacks, he goes, every comic is merely a dancing monkey.
He goes, literally.
Literally. He goes, these people are dancing monkeys.
Fuck.
He goes, I'm pretty sure Geppetto has more brain cells than Brendan Schaub.
He brings up, he goes, the guy can't, he's like, I don't get it. He goes, okay, well, let me explain. Schaub, come over here. He's like, Geppetto, come. He's like, now do you see it? And the guy's like, oh, okay.
Geppetto's got like a tight fade.
Geppetto's wearing thick boy outfit.
He's wearing a bomber jacket.
Geppetto's wearing like fucking like joggers and fucking Nikes.
Johnny Depp's monkey Geppetto is like a hype beast. He's got a podcast.
He has marijuana leaf socks on.
Oh, fuck.
All right. How does he finish this?
It was all, the fuck? No. I thought we were going to play video games, bro.
Joe, can I go in?
Sorry, man.
Make that two.
I love that. No, fuck no. I'm not into that, dude. I'm not. I don't want to be locked down with you anymore. I just. What are you going to do, bro? You're bored.
This would be a bit of a backtrack, so you can not do it if you don't want to, but I kind of love to hear Jake Lamotta do that joke, the gay joke. Do you remember it? He's like, and we fuck each, the one that ended,
play
like,
video
and we
games,
fuck each other.
Me in the quarantine with the boys.
I tuned it out.
All right.
Well, he'll do an next one.
I'll do the next one. I'll pay attention.
Just talking about Lamotta being like, and we fuck each other.
Yeah.
Like saying that punchline.
I wasn't listening.
Was
I would have done
me.
It.
It was
no, I would have done it for you, but I just simply, every word that Chop says
in and out.
Run, exactly.
In and out.
Here's
it doesn't,
more crowd
are you
hours.
Telling me that Brenda doesn't resonate with you?
It just doesn't sink in for some
Brendan
Chop
elevates an audience to a level
he
that we
is reverential.
I mean, these people
he
are
transcends
incredible.
Memory.
These people are having a great night.
Look, he doesn't remember anything
his
either.
CTE
so.
Is contagious. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is Brendan Schaub's starry night.
These people are all happy.
he's painting a picture for us.
Yeah, here's the thing. It's like it's a slow start, but it's all it's setting
it
up.
It ramps up.
It's setting up a crescendo.
Exactly. We're being simpletons. We're putting it in a box.
Yeah, this is merely the fulcrum of the special.
The fulcrum.
Dream. I never thought I'd say this to a live audience, one thing that I'm grateful for the governor of California, Governor Newsom, for locking us down for an entire year and ruining small businesses. Because I wouldn't have realized this unless I was locked down with my family for an entire year. I realized my girl's not cool. She's just not... She's not a friendly human being. I married a goddamn rattlesnake. She's like, this is my girl. This is my girl, man. This is what I'm dealing with. Yo, listen, LA's different than Texas. They just opened up my son's school last week.
He fucks up so many words. It's crazy.
Well, you know, you can't get it out.
He speaks like it's like he's like a table that needs those things under it to even out. He can't connect his words together. Mm-hmm. You got to give him like
his
a
tongue is too big.
His
for His
tongue staff. Needs like a handicap ramp to get to the next fucking word.
Yeah.
In school in a fucking year. They just opened it last week, first day of kindergarten. So I got him his first day outfit.
He somehow has like cauliflower kids. Tongue.
Oh my god. That's like
I'm surprised I haven't seen that homeless, on the subreddit.
That's top comment on a big homeless cat's thread. Yeah,
that is great. That's fantastic.
Yeah. Dicey.
I love the homeless cats. You know, of course we intellectually link up.
Bapa's got cauliflower tongue.
Giant backpack, backwards hat, looks just like me. I'm walking up for school. I'm like, dude, it's about to be lit as fuck. All his little friends out front in their first day outfits. I'm like, oh my god, you guys are cute as shit. I need to document this. I go, T, get tight. There's a bunch of
I need
of
to document this for
tight.
Delia. Chris is gonna love this shit. Chris is gonna love this. He's like, spread your touch your ankles. Touch your ankles real quick and let the gringo Papi take a photo of you for Delia.
He asks all the girls, he goes, who here has tits? Does any of you have tits growing in yet?
You do? Okay, get out of the picture.
All right, get out of the picture. Get in my van. Get in my thick boy van.
Pick.
I'm collecting panties for Delia. Girl.
She gets it. She looks at it. She goes, crop out the uglies. Resend.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Excuse me? That's ruthless, Bapa.
Yo.
Damn.
Dicey,
B.
If that's a true story, his wife is like a psycho.
Yeah, it's like a weird joke. He's like, he's just telling the crowd.
Your wife seems so hateable.
He's like, my wife's an awful human being.
Yeah, just like a horrible person.
Like your wife is an irredeemable trashy human. Piece of shit.
And he like, I think he cheats on her and shit too. And then he just goes,
she deserves it.
She does.
She's actually that type of person.
They deserve each other.
Yeah.
These two trash fucking cocksuckers.
Yeah.
Dumbass.
Here, that you guys missed the punch.
Let's hear that.
Oh.
He goes.
Yeah, he goes, oh, shit.
Can't miss a punchline.
I said, you're in a group chat to other parents, dumbass.
There's a guy going, oh shit.
He goes, snap. What? She said that to the wrong group. Damn. Oh,
what?
Like, oh, what a mistake, brother. Woo.
There's guys in the crowd going like, woo. Doing the ram jam.
It's such a lie, by the way. Like, obviously, this never happened.
No, they're all...
I don't know, though, dude.
It's funny that he can... Okay, when you're doing... You get to make up whatever you
I believe
want.
That his wife...
You get to lie, and he just was like, I don't know, my wife's like a piece of shit.
Here's what happened. No, I believe got home. She liked the photo. He got home, and then she was joking with him. It was like, what if we just crop out the uglies?
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, my God, can you say that?
Yeah.
What if you sent that to
I believe that part,
with everybody
but yeah,
in
he
it.
Didn't do it. Like, she didn't send it to him. The parents. That's like the dumbest fucking lie.
Yeah.
No, not at all.
Oh, sad.
There he goes again.
Yeah, numb that tongue. Numb that tongue with some whiskey.
I married a Mexican.
Married a Mexican.
I thought you would like that. Listen. Listen. I thought you guys would enjoy that. Listen, Dallas.
Listen.
I don't mean like Taco Bell Mexican. No. I'm talking Guadalajara. Born and raised. Came to the States 10 years ago, illegally Mexican. The real deal, holy shit.
What's his wife
by the way,
like?
She's
look up what his wife looks like right now.
She, okay, first off, she's not
She's not from Mexico. Really? She was born and raised. She was born at the Kaiser Permanente down the street.
Oh, so she's bougie.
She's from LA.
She's bougie.
She's from LA. He's just like lying. She's like Guadalajara Mexican.
I know this from being a homeless cat. She has like a weird, huge, fake ass.
She has a fake, huge, fake ass.
And a bunch of the other cats that I'm friends with. A couple of the other boys at Chang's, they put together this montage of Joe Rogan, Shab on Rogan's podcast, where Rogan is clearly just going like, I hate fake asses, dude.
Yeah.
And just like bringing up how fake asses are gross and fake.
Yeah.
And Shab getting uncomfortable because his wife has an actual fake ass.
Yeah.
It's a whole
montage. Is it 100% fake?
Yeah.
It looks like too big.
No, it's like, pull it up. Yeah, you can pull it up.
Like, I don't want to like, you know, I don't want to like dox these people's families.
Who gives a fuck?
No, it's not.
She's been doxed.
It's not her address. It's,
All right, hold on.
The cats.
We got to all the sanctity of the big fake ass.
Yeah, you know.
Shop just beats the shit out of
us. Yeah, type in like fake ass or something. I can't see what you searched.
Oh, there you go.
I love using that tone.
Is that her?
That's her.
So, man, I can't. That doesn't look
like full screen. Full screen it for Joseph.
You know.
Well, you can see. That's not even that bad a one.
Oh no, I think that's just like a fan of his.
That could also, yeah, that could be anybody.
All right, hold on. Let's like go to who Instagram.
You got
to
do Reddit. Just put Reddit in the search as well, because that will bring the homeless cat Reddit results.
Yeah, right,
let's get to the cats. We need some help, cats.
Why would you go anywhere but the cats? It's just like
the homeless my cats boys are, at they Chang's. Have their own search engine.
My boys at Chang's are like flipping out right now.
Where's the PF Chang's joke come from? I mean, I assume Brendan Schaub said it, but like, why?
So
why PF Chang's?
Yeah, so Schaub was like, all these people hating on me in the comments. He's like, it's a bunch of fucking guys working at PF Chang's. He's
that
like,
rocks.
It's a,
and, yeah,
and,
it is.
And then I think it was the same rant where, and then he goes, it's like a bunch of homeless cats, dude.
Oh, okay.
And it's like,
So I was having a stroke.
Yeah, it's you know,
he's all over the place.
Aggression and impaired judgment for CTE.
She's cute though.
Here it is. She's cute.
She's got a pretty face.
Fake asses
stuff.
Don't always look.
I love a chunky.
No,
Latina.
She has a pretty bad one in certain pictures.
Certain pics.
I mean, yeah. This
but
is
listen, I don't. You know, I'm not a judgmental pig. I think everyone's beautiful.
Yeah, that's you know. Yeah,
she looks kind of like. Snooki.
That's not the what are you on her Instagram?
Yeah.
No, go to the Reddit. They have,
I can't find an immediate Reddit thread about her.
This fucking otter can't find.
I think it's a bear trait to be able to use DuckDuckGo.
That's like a picture of her ass. You know?
Yeah, but the Reddit guy, the homeless cats the have ones. The good ones.
Yeah.
Okay. Brendan Schaub, wife, ass, Reddit.
Go Brendan Schaub, wife, fake ass, Reddit, and then maybe even homeless cats.
Actual video evidence of Brendan Schaub cheating on his wife? Click on that.
Let's stay on fucking track here a little bit. We can double back.
You're
otters
right.
Get distracted pretty easily.
These otters, yeah, they have such a tangents. Terrible...
Joe and Brenda on ass ADHD. Implants. Is this the clip?
Yeah, this is what I was talking about.
They don't... When she shows all these pictures of her giant, perfect ass, she's showing an extremely unrealistic representation of a human being. So what she does is she hires
and these shots are
to
of
follow her everywhere and take
Brendan's
pictures.
Wife.
This is the cats doing the editing.
Yeah, the cats. Great editing. So that's her before?
Yeah.
I love the fucking...
What are they zooming in on?
Edit.
Oh, they...
they're going to draw on her like it's Nip Tuck?
So they're taking... yeah.
I love
they take,
the music.
They take the fat.
They cleaned away all the lumps. And then she looks amazing, right?
That is a dumper.
That's gross.
That is a dumper.
Yeah, but here's the thing. That's not real. That is all fat that someone stuffed into your ass like a giant diaper. And when they smooth it out and put it on Instagram with all the retouches and everything like that, this forces
screen.
Women to like think that this is possible, that this is normal.
My girl's ass beats hers, by the way.
But it's real.
It's real.
It's real. It's real.
Oh my God. Do they have evidence it's fully, it's not?
Makes sense.
And she's got a body that makes sense.
The plastic people surgeon is a homeless cat.
What's going on here? Right?
Plastic surgeon's Bobby Lee.
Maybe I'm being a hater. H-A-D-E-R.
You're a hater, B.
A hater.
Hater, yeah.
Hater.
Bapa.
You're being a hater, Bapa. Dicey, hater, dicey.
But I'm almost positive I've seen a picture of her ass where it was
like
just like
good.
So obviously fake.
Mm,
but
okay.
I could be wrong. Maybe I'm being
it
almost
probably
good.
Is.
Hot.
Everyone does cool. It now. Nobody works
no,
out.
She's
done
this
a service.
A real
How
ass.
Dare you?
It's not a real ass. This is a disaster.
I would not kick her out of bed for like, eating fucking graham crackers.
Look at those pictures.
Yeah, I know. Those pictures those are have glorious.
Been sent to a
cartoonist. These aren't that bad. I don't know.
No, these look like...
Totally like that. Well, her thighs are like a little bit too thin for her ass, but...
She didn't get like that where it's done so much that it looks obviously fake. Yeah.
No, I saw worse ones. I know I saw worse ones.
But it ain't
ones.
Great.
She's got a little dumper.
I saw way worse ones than that. So that's not what I was talking about. Whatever.
All right.
Let's get back to business.
Can we get back to fucking business, okay? For Christ's sakes.
Yeah.
I haven't even gotten into
that. That was trash. Let's watch art.
Oh, this shit is... I did a lot of
you gotta put it on the screen.
Flat asses before her, and just never worked out for me. It just would never work out. And I'll forget this.
Honor. Sorry that I'm, you know, I'm the producer, host. I'm everything of this goddamn podcast. I do everything.
Not a great one.
Huh?
Dude,
struggling, huh?
Bro. Get with a Latina, bro. You know why? Because they're fun and they're spicy. No doubt, definitely spicy. Real spicy, right? Real spicy. You know what spicy means? They're assholes. That's what that means.
What do you think about that one? Imagine Jake Lamotta. He's like, yeah, my wife, you know, one of these Mexicans.
He goes, you know how
spicy.
They say the food is spicy. in Mexico, it's spicy. He goes, this is good. It talking, it's because of the ass. The ass is spicy. It's what.
Oh my god!
He goes, all of you. I think you're the fool. Going, I don't know. See the ass. Not spicy, eh?
say Bapa.
Hey, okay, Bapa.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Jake, are you a thick boy?
Thick, yeah. Me, my friends, we get together in Santa Monica. We get our bicycles. We all wear the same T-shirt. It says "Thick Boy." it's a small but loyal community, and we ride our bikes down, you know, four blocks. It's not a big ride, but it's enough for us to get together. And then we go to the food trucks. We have our fill on lobster rolls, and, you know, we're sweating because we're all fat pigs. And then I charge them $50 for an autograph, and I send them home.
Jake Lamotta, Brendan Shaw!
I'm sorry, man. Dude, when we first got together, she was cooking authentic Mexican food. Seven nights.
We can't actually watch the whole thing. Maybe
let's do it.
Maybe we can.
I would love to stop.
No, it's I would love to stop too, actually. But
we could do him talk. We could do them. It's different Bobby Lee talking.
It's different with Joey and John here, so it's not the same.
Yeah, view. as the Patreon, but.
I'm completely.
I feel at this point I just feel bad for our Patreon subscribers that they now have to watch the special twice. Though they do have us talking.
But there's some commentary. Let's just listen to the last song because I thought the last song was really sick.
What'd you say about our Patreon?
No,
I love them.
Patreon guys,
cancel.
You get a different. They get a different view.
Oh, okay.
They get a different view. They got you and Wells.
Oh, you're saying who gives a shit?
With the full crew. All right.
So you're saying who?
And we're not going to do this the whole episode.
Of course, we love them.
We're not going to do this the whole episode.
I happen to love everybody.
You guys, can we watch the closer? Can we watch the mountain lion closer? Because Brendan had a mountain lion, and so he got a gun, and then but he didn't realize mountain lions were mountain lions. And then and then at the end of his last joke, he just goes like, "So it was a goddamn mountain. It was big." All right, thank you, Dallas. That's like the joke.
Ow. Well, no, dumbass. It's a line of the mountains, dude. It's fucking. This thing was Mufasa. Fucking.
I think I could watch.
Oh, he's doing a Callan thing.
Yeah.
I honestly think I could watch Joey doing Jake Lamotta just like verbatim doing the whole special, like 25 minutes of just Joey staying.
If
Jake
Joey
Lamotta,
was Jake Lamotta care. Doing all these same jokes, it'd be like the funniest thing
goes,
that's ever happened on Earth.
I thought I heard mountain lion. I said, "What is that? Probably a little small cat, something like that." So I go out there, you know. I'm like, "Oh, whatever, whatever."
They go, oh, big fucking, the biggest cat I've ever, big fucking closet, man. They go, big, huge, way bigger than a cat, regular cat. I goes, couldn't believe it. I go, it actually, now it makes sense. It's a lion. It's a lion of the mountain. You know, makes perfect. The name actually matches. It's good. Good description. Good. Very good.
Oh, that's so good.
whoever named it, named spot on with that big cat, big dirty mountain cat.
Big dirty mountain cat.
All right, here we go. It's about to end.
Dan, pull it up on the screen.
I panicked, dude. I panicked. I went, oh shit! I slammed the door. Dude, I threw my AR-15 like this. I fucking threw my night vision. I'm not even left-handed. I was like, oh my god. Still got my UGG boots. Still got the big dick. Not a big deal.
Still got my UGG boots. My big dick.
As long as I got my big dick.
I'm sorry. No, let's move on.
Yeah, the UGG boots. Big dick.
You know, pretty good.
As long as I got my big dick. my wife's giant fake ass. Every night.
I got on that Ring app the next morning. I went, yo, we got a mountain lion problem, y'all.
That's the closer.
That was the big ending.
The bass starts playing.
The bass plays him. He plays himself off. With his own music.
He goes, I got in the Ring app, and then I told my neighbors there's a mountain lion.
Who's this guy getting up
thick
on stage?
Boy,
it's the host or whatever. His closer is literally like... He's like, so I put my right shoe on, put my left shoe on. He goes, I got both shoes on, y'all. Thank you.
Because now I'm wearing both shoes.
He goes,
all right, peace.
He goes, now I'm wearing both shoes. He's like, thick boy nation.
He puts a cane around his own waist and drags himself off the stage.
He goes, $600 to meet me after the show. Peace.
Fuck. This song is sick, though.
It's really sick. This song gets me going. Oh!
Kiss shit.
New way class like I'm...
Clocking in at Chang's. Homeless cats run the show.
See, I'm a fan now. Just because of this song.
The song is kind of dope.
I forgive him for everything.
It's a great song.
He's just a slick editor. I think that's his trick.
Yeah. Thick boy squad. Thick boy squad. Thick boy nation. Thick boy squad.
Is Bill Burr in their fucking crew?
No.
Well, what the fuck was that picture?
It was just a picture, like
but they're trying. When Thick Boy Squad started
Bill
playing
was just
on the
at
fucking
the comedy
he
store,
he took a picture with Bill Burr.
Know,
but
picture.
You have a picture boy. With Bill Burr. It's like anyone.
I know. But when the Thick Boy Squad started going, it was like then that. Picture
no, he's not a member. Bill Burr is not a member of the Thick Boy Squad. Imagine Bill Burr. No.
Of course, I'm fucking with you. Probably, I know that, but it's funny. It's a funny edit.
He's probably a little frustrated that this picture's in the special.
Yeah, you know some.
Thick boy.
I'm a part of the thick boy squad now. Sometimes you just gotta, you gotta clock into Chang's, you know?
I went over to Chang's. I was like, just checking in on you.
He goes, you know, I'm in a part of Thick Boy Nation. We get a lot of ladies.
Because normally, you know, Thick Boy Squad, bit of a bro whisper, you know? But thank God there's some ladies at the show tonight.
All right. Oh, so that wraps up the Gringo Puppy. I mean, I don't know. Do you guys want to watch Bobby Lee talk about him getting bullied by Brendan Schaub, apparently?
Is this real? What do you guys think?
Well, you know what? There is a better clip, I think,
is there?
To watch. There's one where Schaub...
Well, Brendan Schaub goes on fucking Tiger Belly, man.
Well, Schaub... goes on his own podcast and gets really sad about the homeless cats.
Oh, really? Let's watch that.
Yeah.
I like
I mean,
that.
What else?
Yeah, yeah. So he starts saying, because there's a million clips of Schaub going, like,
tell Jamie,
he's like,
what
I don't,
to look
I don't read the comments. He's like, none of that shit hurts my feelings. They're all homeless cats.
Brendan Schaub was on
Tiger Belly. Yeah.
Tiger Belly?
Yeah.
Oh, new.
New?
Oh, yeah, one day ago. Yesterday.
Wait.
I wish there were like highlights.
I'm going to ease
in. We can't put the whole thing
on. No, I know. I mean,
what are we doing?
I don't want to do
this. We're turning into Red Bar now.
Yeah. Rest in peace, too, by the way. Apparently, I don't know.
He passed away?
Somebody told me online he's like dead. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with Red Bar. Maybe.
Oh, man.
He's
Devan
gone.
Recently told me, by the way, he was. I let him in to use my gym.
I just sat at a coffee shop watching Red Bar.
And here's what he did. Yeah, he flooded the toilet at my coffee shop in my building.
I was watching Red Bar videos.
Watching Red Bar. He
took a dump.
He took such a long dump watching Red Bar that he flooded the toilet, couldn't fix it, and then just ran out.
I ran out.
Of course.
I ran out.
Well, you're not going to go report it. You have to run out.
Who the fuck reports?
But it's kind of crazy to go into my bathroom at my coffee shop that I go to every day, flood it while watching Red Bar, and then just sprint away without fixing it.
I wasn't trying.
I've literally reported when I've clogged toilets at restaurants.
I didn't clog.
You're proud of it. John's proud.
Well, here's the
thing. I've vomited in toilets at restaurants when I just vomited in there.
John, by the way, this is a sidebar, but we're John shit his pants at the cream.
Almost, I'd curse at that fucking place. I almost you did shit it my
again.
Pants.
Again,
almost shit my pants again.
So we went back to the site where John shit his pants at the cream barbecue. Same exact place.
Almost shit
and
my pants.
Mudai Po too. We went there, and so John
he starts like puking and shit.
Well, so first of all, he in the middle of the meal, he goes, "Oh." He goes, "Dude, I'm gonna shit my fucking pants."
What is with your bowels?
Dude, and then it's Mudai Po. It's fucking cursed. I haven't done that in years.
It's what?
It's Mudai Po.
What's Mudai Po?
I'm cursed there.
That's where he shit his pants.
Oh, but
it's like they play the brown noise while I'm there. It's crazy. It's like in the background is some Korean guys in a booth upstairs just going to it.
It's like it's like a Spassky versus Fisher. They're beaming the brown note down into his brain. But so he claims that he's about to shit his pants. He goes, takes a massive dump, comes back. Then he orders so much food.
Listen, cocksucker. All right, I didn't to be fair. Okay, I didn't know it'd be that much chicken. All right, the meat would have been light work.
It was a lot.
Okay, meat was light work.
Well, it was they bring two out chicken breasts.
These fuckers bring out two butterfly chicken breasts, big chicken breasts.
Yeah.
They're right.
They're pretty boring, too, to get chicken.
No, it's spicy chicken.
It's decent. Yeah. It's decent.
And you always do one chicken.
And then we're not even eating it, but we cook it. And then it's like, Joey's like, "I'm tapping out, bud."
Mm-hmm. Well, because
I got 8 pounds of meat.
Or they charge you for it.
Or they charge
us
$30.
Well, why don't you just hide it in the salad and stuff like I do?
We did that. We didn't have enough salad left.
I go, we should just use Devin's trick. Let's hide it. I bring that up every time I go to any Korean barbecue place.
I
tell everybody that I go, if you're not there, I go, my friend Devan hides the extra in the salad.
Mm-hmm. There were times me and my friends, we used to put it in our pockets and go to the bathroom and just throw it in the toilet so we wouldn't have to pay.
Let's just explain this, because Korean barbecue isn't that
it's
well
not
known.
Everywhere. Korean barbecue is a thing where you go, you pay like maybe $20, and they bring you unlimited amounts of raw meat, and you cook it, and there's all sorts of little, they give you little side dishes, kimchi, fucking weird
salad.
Beans.
The banchan.
All sorts of crap.
It's good.
And it's great. It's like it's really awesome. Fun, and it's like a communal like experience, and you can just eat for hours and drink and have a great time. But if you're getting, you know, too big for your britches and you start thinking I'm going to keep eating. I'm starving. And you order tons of, you know, meat, then they bring it and then you're like, holy shit, I'm fucking full. And by the time there's a ton of raw meat on your table, you're like, you have to pay for all that if you don't let you take it home.
Koreans are, I don't want to say cheap, but they're like conservative. They're slow to bring you, water. They're not going to ask you, do you need another refill? So
you got to hunt them down.
What ended up, I think what they realized is like people kept just being a little bit, their eyes were bigger than their stomach, and they would order an extra 3 plates and then not finish it, and there was no punishment. So they started doing a thing where they say, okay, if you do that, if we see an unacceptable amount of meat left on the table, we're doubling your bill.
Yeah, your bill goes up.
At this place, it's doubled bill.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
And they
usually it's by weight or whatever. But they just know Americans are so fat and stupid, they're just going to keep like ordering
didn't comprehend that I would eat the food then just puke it in their parking lot.
Yeah.
But real quick, though, Devin's big scam
was... So my scam was I would go with my friends, we'd do that all the time, and we'd be like, holy shit, I'm so stuffed. Like, and there's tons of food left on the table that we haven't cooked. So we would just like usually like hide it like in the salads and the sides that they gave us, or... If we didn't have any like salad left, we would just like grab it with our hands, put it in our pockets, and like each take turns going to the bathroom. Like it's a great escape. Like we're letting dirt, like we're letting dirt out that we've been like digging. We've been digging a hole, and we like, what do we do with all this dirt? We're gonna get caught. Like we go outside, you know, during a recess, and we let it out of our pockets.
You slip it out of the bottom of your pants.
Yeah, bottom of my pants. So that's what we would do with the Korean barbecue. Works every time. But like so
John did the mistake of ordering way, way too much.
I ordered 3 plates of meat. Two of the what fucked us was the chicken.
No, you ordered 3, like the in brisk, 4 the, different rounds.
The red meat.
Honestly, if you order chicken and cream barbecue, you're kind of like a fucking...
No, that was your chicken. Order. That was your order. You wanted the chicken.
It's a stupid, stupid move.
I didn't want the chicken.
I don't think so. I've ordered chicken. You've ordered chicken.
Listen.
I've seen you order chicken.
Well, it's chicken.
When they bring the meat out, it's usually not a lot of meat. It's usually like a little plate of meat. Like, if you get intestines, 2 intestines.
Well, they saw you. They were like,
John, by the way, ordered intestines.
They saw John. They ordered intestines. Thick boy
squad here.
Yeah, I'm here. I walk in there, they're like, fucking, oh shit.
Yeah.
I had 3 Diet Cokes, and it wasn't free refills. I just kept ordering Diet Cokes, yeah.
Was it in cans?
In cans.
What is with Asians in the cans? Get a fucking soda machine!
Like, if we get fountain, then it must be free.
Joey's sitting there. Fountain. At one point, I'm ordering my 3rd Diet Coke, and Joey just, nobody's, you know, they're like aloof. All the servers are aloof. And just Joey just goes, get this hero Diet Coke.
Yeah, because I literally couldn't eat one more bite. And John's like, all right, I can do this, dude. All right. I got big horse legs, dude. He's like, I can do this. I think I can do it. There was so much meat. He's like, but I think I'm going to need a Diet Coke. So I go, all right, Diet Coke for the hero. Bring it over. Bring it over now. Yeah.
Well, it's always fun to drink carbonated beverages while you're eating a ton because then you burp and you feel like you gained some room, but you really didn't.
It's an illusion.
And you keep going. Yeah, you also have to eat like really fast, and that's why Korean barbecue, the waiters, they take their time to bring you the food because they want you to fill up.
Exactly.
They're snakes.
That's why you gotta wave them
over.
I'm
gonna start giving my order while just putting the waiter in a chokehold. It's like good. I'm in fucking, what's it called? Roadhouse. Anyways,
used to go to Korean barbecue, and we would these people hated us when I was in high school.
Which one was
shit.
It?
It was like $9.99.
Oh, it was the castle.
Like, the meat was like a castle. Yeah. It was the cheapest shit ever. There was a pack of people out front waiting to get tables. It was horrific, but like it was great. It still was fun. And we used to go and to get our money's worth because we all had no money, and $10 was like a lot to us at the time. We'd all take turns going out into a car and smoking a blunt. Like we'd eat. We'd get all full, and then we'd sit there and act like we're still like, no, like, keep it coming. And then we'd each take turns going to the car and, like, getting insanely high and regenerating our appetites. Smart. And we'd come in, and they would just
get our money's worth.
Why are they still here? We were there for like three hours.
My friends and I would have days where, we were broke like that. It was in high school. And we would just, the day leading up to Korean barbecue, we'd only eat lettuce to expand our stomachs. Mm. And to like just make us really hungry so that when we go to get Korean barbecue.
Is that a thing really with lettuce?
My buddy was like, if you eat a bunch of lettuce, it'll expand.
That sounds like high school. Stoner bullshit where stoners are like,
and we get insanely high and we go to Korean barbecue.
Drink orange juice. If you like smoke weed and like eat a mango, like the citrus and the mango, like
you get you higher,
you
bro.
You go like, you get so much higher.
So John is being a hero. He decides to eat this insane amount of food. It was really actually impressive. I couldn't believe how much he ate.
I hated it.
He hated it. It was
not fun. It turned the evening into just not a pleasant
It was like a Korean torture. I was sweating on the amount that I ate. I was miserable.
Sweating. I'm sitting there and it's horrible.
He was so miserable and like he was not having fun. It ruined the night.
Oh, fucked up.
It really it fucked
I
up.
I want to get Korean barbecue Joey and have a nice walk.
No walk for you.
Go get a coffee.
He finishes it.
Go to Tom Tom's, get one of those Korean coffee place that look they stole the Starbucks logo, but they just called it Tom Tom.
Yeah, exactly.
It's literally the Starbucks logo, but they just go Tom Tom.
Everything's like brown sugar this.
Everything
like,
in Koreatown, they just get to the point of everything. Like the bank is called Open Bank.
Open Bank 3.
Every fucking Asian like business, they just get straight to the point. It's what's like with the donut numbers? In mouth 24 hour.
Yeah, and they all have a carbonara on the menu for some reason.
They love carbonara.
Every Korean has like a weird carbonara.
Koreans are obsessed. They love fattening American dishes. They love like cheesy fried.
Dude, there was a coffee
fettuccine Alfredo.
There was an actual coffee shop behind my apartment in Koreatown, my first apartment. That yellow weird coffee shop.
Yeah,
they had. Alfredo. That was their only food.
Yeah.
They had bacon Alfredo. It was like a carbonara.
No, that's like a classic, like, it's like comfort food for Koreans. They love, like...
But so anyways, John does this. We go outside, and we're about... We got to take this walk. And I actually have video footage of this, and we're going to release it on the Patreon.
Yeah.
It's John walking out of this thing and puking in the parking lot in broad daylight in front of, like... It's like a lot of people could have seen him. Mm. Puked in the parking lot, and then... So that's on video. But then after that, not on video, we went on the walk, and he was puking for about 45 minutes.
Damn. I just kept fucking having...
Here's the thing. I want to make fun of John, but I have an even sadder story. When I was in Brooklyn alone for doing that show like a month ago, I...
Pause.
It was Sam J. Yeah. May 20th. I don't know.
HBO.
They probably cut me from it, but...
Did they?
I have no idea, but I, you know, the things I said, who knows?
They're getting a bomb if they did, but go on.
So they put me up at this like nice hotel for like a night. And so I'm like, hell yeah. Like, you know, I feel like a big shot. You know, I'm getting...
What'd you do,
for Christ's sakes, I'm getting a whole 600 smackaroos for this.
I'm rich.
So I'm like, whatever. I don't know. It's like rainy and cold, but I'm like, I'm going to fucking explore Brooklyn on my own. And I go out.
You're like
and
a
I'm
Bob like, Dylan album cover.
Yeah.
Like in your jacket.
Exactly.
It's all rainy.
My North Face.
Yeah. Devin's like,
I'm in Williamsburg. So like, I'm walking around and I go to an Italian restaurant and I get like a ton of drinks and I like stuff my face with like Italian food, like tons of fucking pasta and shit. And it's like not even that good. It's just one of those hipster places where they opened up like their whatever.
Yeah.
I thought it would be good because Google Maps said it would. It sucked. And then I'm walking around. I'm like disgustingly full. Connor can't hang out with me. Like nobody can hang with me that night. So I'm just like low. I'm like fucking Travis Bickle, like wandering around in like a North Face jacket.
One day, real rain's going to wash the scum off these streets.
With a stomach full of pasta. And then I go to a bar and I like stupidly start drinking like beer, like pounding like IPAs and watching like a Nets game on my own. And then I'm like, I get like intensely like sick. Like I'm like, oh my God. Cause I think if you eat and then drink beer, the food, the, you know, it's like shaking a beer. Like it starts foaming. And I felt just like disgusting. Right. So then I can't even, I it's the first time in my life I've never finished my drink. I left like half a beer on the counter and I closed out and I walk over to the Hudson River where the hotel was like right on the water. It was like beautiful. And I'm walking down a side street and this lady's walking her like poodle by me. And I'm just like, ugh. And right as she's about to pass me, I'm like, no! I throw up everywhere. I throw up so much fucking gnocchi and chicken parmesan. And I felt so good. And then she's like looking at me like, oh my God. And I like walk away, but I'm like all happy. I'm like, I feel fucking great. I like, I jumped in the air.
The
I like tap my feet together like at the end of a movie.
Just for like a million bucks.
I went back to the hotel and I got really fucked up on my own.
I was at the Gold Line station the other week and this fucking like heroin addict gets off the train. And the second he gets off the train, he stumbles on the train and just immediately just goes, and he just vomits on the ground. It was like projectile vomits on the ground. And then this like paisa behind him wearing like a cowboy hat. He walks up to the guy. The guy's like kneeling, like what do you call it? Reeling over like a rail. And he's just like laying there. And the guy goes, "You okay, buddy? You good? Are you good?"
Uh-huh.
And the guy's just not responding. And I'm just like, what the fuck is going on? And then the vice dude looks at me and just goes, yeah, yeah! And walks away.
Yeah, yeah!
He does that fucking, yeah!
I puked. I pilked. What is that? What is it called?
Yeah, he did that. Yeah. It was amazing.
What
was
is
like,
that,
fuck.
Richie, what is that restaurant in Santa Monica on the ocean? It's called like Hillstones?
Yeah, Hillstones.
Yeah.
Oh, Hillstones.
That's one of them, yeah.
No, wait, okay, Hillstones, I think, yeah. It's like right on, like the view is the ocean, right?
Hillstones a little bit back.
Fuck, I'm thinking the wrong place. But whatever, it's
meet
like...
Meet on ocean?
No. It's like down the street from where we lived with Timish. And if you like went down toward...
the ocean.
No, toward... fuck, what is the... where did Tony Stark live? Malibu.
Malibu, yeah.
So whatever.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Redstone.
Oh,
Redstone.
Whatever.
Something Hook.
I think Redstone.
Red Hook.
Called.
know.
Redstone, whatever. Anyways, whatever. Some restaurant.
Treadstone.
Me and my friend Johnny, who's like a sophisticated family man, I got drunk with him and his family, and then I like fell asleep at his house. Like, let's go to this restaurant tomorrow morning and have like a nice little lunch. And we got there, and they're like, let's just get a bottle of wine to share. And I instantly chug it. I started ordering so many drinks. I ate such an insane amount of food. And then, like, I was fucking blackout drunk with him and his wife and his kids. And they're like, we got to go home. And, like, we'll see you later, Joey. Like, we... And I was like, okay, bye. And I just stayed there, and I kept getting drunker and drunker. And then all of, like, the seafood and the pasta and everything that I ate, I walked, like, three steps outside, and there's, like, instant beach. And I sat down on the, they have a big boulder, like, right outside of it. Yeah. I was just sitting there, like, trying to breathe and not puke. And then just, like, it just hit me all at once. And it was the most insane amount of puke that you could ever imagine. Just, like, fucking gallons of puke. Like, it was like The Exorcist. I was just puking and puking. And there was, like, families walking by me just, like, laughing. And I was just, like a homeless cat. I was covering it up with sand. I was kicking sand over my puke. It was the most embarrassing thing ever.
I remember.
You're disgusted by yourself.
I made myself sick, but again, right now. But so that's my puke story. I guess
I had in high school. In high school, I used to. Do you ever remember when you first like started smoking? You never smoked cigs, but I remember when I would get really drunk in high school, and then I'd take like one puff of a cigarette, and I'd have to puke.
Thank you.
That ever happen to you, Joey?
There's a thing I know where people
get nauseous. Yeah.
So I remember that was like that would happen all the time to me in high school. And I remember I was at this girl's New Year's Eve party, and I was like 16, and I'm like really fat. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm just a monster. And I'm leaving her fucking house, and I take a drag of a cigarette, and I just I gotta vomit now. So I go over to this like hedge, and I just like puke into this hedge, and out of nowhere, this little dog just comes up and starts eating my vomit. Oh. And I remember just looking down at it. I'm like, oh, God. And I just start puking again, and I cover the dog with my puke. I puke all over the little white dog. It's this little white dog.
He puked on a dog.
It was this little white dog. And I remember the dog was just fucking covered in my vomit.
Oh,
and I just, I go back inside, and I remember I'm sitting there just acting like nothing happened. And then all of a sudden, I just hear this girl just, did somebody fucking puke on my dog? And it was like, oh, fucking my buddies went to the In-N-Out in Glendale. It was great. Man.
Oh my god.
Great night. Never found out.
That's great.
Mm. Poor dog. You're a fucking scumbag.
Puked on a dog. But yeah, I puked the Korean barbecue out, and then I was convinced that speaking of dogs, I had a fucking tear in my stomach.
It was his classic jiu-jitsu.
Convinced
stuff.
He has a what in his stomach?
He goes, I got a stomach tear, dude. Oh, he's like, bro, I got a stomach tear. He's like,
I was straining my fucking stomach.
I can't take a deep breath, dude. I might go to the hospital.
So I was like, do I have to go to the fucking, it was so much pain, I couldn't take a full breath, and it was like a sharp pain every time I got to here. I was like, dude, I just rip a hole in my fucking stomach.
Recently?
Vomiting. Yeah, when I was at the fucking Korean barbecue.
Oh, the Korean barbecue?
So I'm sitting there, I'm just like, let me recover for a little bit on a wall. And then this like cute girl, by the way, there's like a bunch of my puke next to me because I'm just sitting on a wall. And then Joey's sitting next to me in DMX pants. And this cute girl walks by with a dog. And I just heard Joey looking at her going, hello, doggy, as it's going by. And she looked at us with this absolute look of just revulsion.
Yeah, John's got like puke all over his mouth.
We're two men in our like all 30s just sitting there.
I wonder if we'll ever grow out of this. I hope we go. I hope we get to like, I hope we're like this.
I hope we don't.
Oh, we
I hope we're like.
By the way,
honestly, like our biggest win would be like Joey and I are like 55, and we're like we went back to Smoke City Char Bar. We harassed them again.
No, we're still getting 86.
25 years later, we brought another homeless man into a new establishment.
I will never grow out of this. I know a lot of old people who haven't grown out of it. They're kind of our canary in the coal mine.
Yeah.
I hope that in the future there's a story where we're like, yeah, and Devin, we're outside Red Line. He beat a guy with his cane.
Well, listen, we'll be married with kids and stuff, but we at least have to maintain some integrity.
We have to do so. Yeah. We have to keep it up.
Yeah. Oh, God.
We got to be aging degenerates.
Yes.
Yes.
We have to age gracefully as degenerates.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, the minute anyone gets boring, you're out.
I fucking couldn't agree more.
You're out of the crew.
Couldn't agree more.
Truly.
Stakes are high.
We've already lasted this long.
If you guys ever have a period of your life where you go, where I like try to talk about like a TV show or a movie or anything or an album or anything, and you guys go like, I haven't seen a movie in years. I'm busy. I have, you know, kids and life. That's those people. Shivers up my spine.
That's so
scary. Shivers up my spine. You're a sicko.
Kids are the hardest.
People that don't take the time to at least consume themselves with some media.
I know a lot of people with kids that have managed to stay cool. So,
oh, really?
Yeah. Yes.
Cool.
But because they didn't give up. It's not okay to give up. Exactly. Don't
you gotta
be
set
okay
aside
with that.
Time.
I hate when people act like, hey, I'm an adult. I know about nothing going on at all in the culture or in the news.
I'm beaten down by life. I go to work. I come home. The wife's a handful. Yeah. Like, what am I supposed to do?
Who's Joe Rogan?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
All right. Enough of you. Christmas. There's always some fucking jizz bag like that. There's always some guy. There's always somebody at some family event where you're like,
he goes, I am learning a lot right now from you guys.
Yeah, exactly. They always say that.
God, kill yourself.
Ugh. What happened?
What's TikTok?
To you? Yeah, exactly.
And you show them and they're like, this is great.
You know, yeah, so I was, you know, puking our guts off, then we sneak in the Langham. Get to the roof of the Langham.
This is kind of a good one, I guess.
It was beautiful. We're just sitting there.
We went on a walk to Koreatown.
Yeah, we did an infiltration real quick.
And so, yeah, we walked by.
They're filming a Bosch outside the Langham.
They're filming a Bosch.
Yeah.
There's a security guard sitting in a chair, and I told John, I'm like, the only time they ever put a security guard right there on that street is if they're filming something in the Langham.
Yeah.
And every time they're filming something in the Langham, they keep the back gate open because that's where the film guys bring their shit in.
Mm-hmm.
So we can go in, sneak up to the roof. So we walk over to the gate, and there's security at the gate, and they're like eating pizza. And I go, ho, you get enough for everybody? And they're like, ha-ha. And like, okay, cool, guys. See you later.
Have a good night, buddy. All those things. Yeah, just real buddy.
Walked right by.
They gave me chills.
Yeah.
So slick.
Just a couple of diseased bears being as slick as you could imagine.
Oh, God. We could be sneaky as fuck sometimes.
No, like,
honestly. We're talking to every security guard we come across.
We should work for the CIA. Yeah, we're approaching security.
I can get into North Korea just talking to Koreans. I just walk across the 38th parallel. Just
drop me and John.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, exactly. Drop us off, you know, in Russia, and we'll end it in, you know, 5 seconds. But so, yeah, go up, another big fats on the roof, security guard. We're like, you guys making a Bosch? He's like, oh, yeah, blah, 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 blah.
Explain that joke real quick. I don't know how many people.
Every time they're filming something in LA, it's an episode of Bosch.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, that is true.
That's the joke.
See trailers anywhere and they're like shutting down a street, it's because they're doing a Bosch.
They're doing a Bosch.
Season 43.
Season 40, yeah, exactly.
I know.
But literally, like, by my apartment, Devin and like used to come over for like weeks and weeks and maybe months in a row, and it was just always Bosch.
Bosch every time.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't find parking.
Anyway,
of Bosch.
So we get to the roof and we have a nice little moment. We had a lot of memories up on that roof.
We did a French kiss.
Oh,
yo, and then we fought.
We played video games. We fuck.
No, it was nice. It was a nice little walk.
No, that was kind of the end of the story. We infiltrated. We went in, snooped around. We harassed security guards. Yeah. Kind of had our way with the place, and then we just bailed. But yeah, that was a fun night. John puked 100 times.
Yeah. It's fantastic. Honestly, I feel a little less guilty about eating Korean barbecue.
Look at Devin texting on his own podcast. This is the most unprofessional fucking scumbag.
I was writing on the Fighter and the Kid subreddit real quick.
You're pathetic.
I have an alias.
This is so unprofessional. I'm sorry.
Alias on the Fighter and the Kid is Bobby Lee.
Let me just do a quick announcement. Joey from the podcast. Thank you for listening.
Manscaped promo code HateWatch.
Don't buy that. He was just texting in the middle of the podcast. If you buy that, you have no integrity and you should be ashamed of yourself. I'm talking to everybody.
I wasn't texting. I was writing a review.
It's on video.
I was writing a review on Pornhub.
Now listen to me.
It was a great Bang Bros
clip. Why do you hate Manscaped so much? What is your deal with
Manscaped? They scammed Devin into perpetuity.
They did not scam.
It is a scam.
No, we no,
it's
no,
what every
no, no,
it's
no.
every podcast.
No, we
it's
want
the start.
People to use promo code HateWatch.
Promo code HateWatch. 20% off everything.
Or
free 15, shipping.
Is it
free shipping. 20% off. Free shipping.
When you found out about this contract, you were furious. Well, how did Devan like snake charm you into thinking
no,
that
no,
it was
no,
okay?
Because it's not an official contract.
You're misconstruing two separate events. I have no problem with the result of this trial run offer or whatever comes from. We'll ride it out. What I was annoyed with is that Devan blindly signed his name on something.
Yeah. It's kind of my
like
thing.
An
to
idiot.
Sign. I just, I kind of sign.
I kind of, you know, it's kind of cool.
I love signing anything.
It's hilarious.
Kind of a badass
makes
move.
Me feel. It makes me feel.
He goes,
fucking,
yeah, bring that over. I'll sign it. Get it
I
out
love
here.
It. I love it. It's because
it's
I,
hilarious.
No one's ever going to ask me for an autograph, so I'm no, just like, yeah, give me that contract.
No, but my
no, it
my
makes
big
me
point.
Laugh, but my mother.
Okay, forget about the contract. Forget about that. My big point was the guy texts on his own podcast. If you're paying for a Patreon subscription, cancel it. Just simply cancel it. This is disrespectful.
You're just trying to get out of the fight.
You're trying to get out of the fight.
He's
you're getting all nervous.
To get, he's trying to get
we're,
out of the fight.
We're gaining money every day. We're almost at 1,000. We'll be at 1,000 next month.
Korean barbecue.
And you're going to have to get, we're going to, you know, and we've given you many outs. We've told you for the last year, you don't have to do this.
You don't
you
have to
always
do
tell
it.
Us you have to. And then you always like up the ante. You're like, I don't even think it should be an amateur. I think I should fight John Jones.
I'm not fighting unless it's Daniel
yeah,
Cormier.
You're, you make it even worse for yourself. You're like, I'm not going to fight until the guy has a, you know, he has an undefeated record.
No. These are two separate things. First of all, if you have an ounce of integrity, cancel your subscription to the Patreon. That's number one. No.
Why do you say that?
Why are you doing this?
This is great, actually, because it bothers you, too. Nobody's going to cancel.
Counterproductive bit.
No, I'm saying, guys, really, if you're like
people online love to do shit for a bit. They'll be like, yeah, good, funny stuff, Joe.
Guys,
just canceled.
No, cancel it and then message me and say that you canceled.
If you can provide Joey a screenshot with you unsubscribing from the Patreon, what will you do?
I'll send them $50. I will send, if you cancel, I will send you $50. show me proof. And if
all right, you're officially panicking about the fight.
He wants receipts. Yeah.
This is official.
You can get out of it, Joe.
You don't have to do this.
Nice.
You
guys they're trying to do honor mind games.
This is
otter
tactics.
Of course, it's an otter tactics.
It's
okay to
we're
feel
a couple
fear.
Oiled up otters dealing with these slippery otters dealing with you fucking, you know, you
these otters have
bears
oily,
with no emotional
wet
intelligence.
Yeah, they got
oily wet
hair
and they you can't grab onto them. So what I was
afraid of the fight.
I secrete like ink.
You do?
Yeah.
Onto contracts that you didn't read.
I secrete ink onto contracts.
Okay, so anyways, let me finish my point here. Okay, so first point is cancel the Patreon, I'll give you $50. Second point is either way, I'm going to do the fight even if we don't get to 1,000.
No, we have to get to
because
1,000.
Because hopefully we never get there because people will cancel.
No, they won't.
Hopefully they don't. They cancel.
We have to get to. What did we say last time? If we get to $1,000. No, if we get to 5,000, we upped the ante. We said that we were going to do something even crazier.
We're going to do the hike or some shit or
something.
What else?
No one cares about the hike.
No, what else was the other one?
We had another one. We'll think about it later.
But so anyways, I'm going to do the fight, and I've been training this week so far. I've run 22.5 miles.
I know, I've seen you. We've been gym rats.
You've been
together.
Coming with me. You're a gym rat.
I'm a goddamn
Devan's
gym rat.
Devan's been training hard.
Within 1 week, I immediately saw results.
You look.
What are you doing?
He's killing
it. I do 9 miles on the bike because I don't.
Nine is crazy, by the way.
Nine miles.
My friend Brock just bragged about doing like 4 miles. It's like.
Yeah, it's pathetic.
Pathetic.
I watch Red Barn. I do 9 miles on the bike.
Yeah,
and
then I see him lifting in the room, and he does the.
I lift and
the
I do
rows.
The rower thing, and then I do that weird like the where you hold yourself up and you do like those sit ups kind of the ab thing. I do that. I do 10 of those
ab lifts.
I only do 10 because I abs.
I do 20 and I'm gassed.
Abs
up.
Are hard, and then I leave. I sit at coffee shops and I take shits.
Look at my vein when I.
Which one? Let me see.
On the video.
Oh, that is a great looking vein.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude.
But so, anyways.
Look how vascular.
Wow.
Thanks, man. But so, I'm doing the fight. I've been running like crazy because here's my thought on the fight. There's no way that I'm going to be better at actual technical boxing in 8 to 12 weeks than an actual guy that's been training for years. What I might be able to do is have better cardio.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
I think he's been training for 10 years.
No, but no, not 10 years. An amateur guy that doesn't see me coming, who underestimates me.
How often is he training?
We're talking about an amateur that doesn't, we don't know yet. Some amateur, pick it up like, some mark that like is like out of season. He doesn't have a fight coming up. We target him. He underestimates me.
If you want to see the fight, to the Patreon subscribers, a little curveball for you. Cancel your Patreon subscription. Send it to Joey. Get $50, put it back into the Patreon, get us to 1,000, force him into the fight.
Yeah, somebody just give us...
No, I'm going to release the fight for free.
Just give us 80 bucks. Give us like 100 bucks and we'll be at 1,000 and Joey will have to do it immediately.
No, yeah, we're so close.
No, but actually all the boxing stuff is going to be on Patreon.
Yeah, Patreon only.
And Richie and I are going to get together... And we've been planning stuff and talking to boxing gyms.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we already have a lot of good stuff filmed. Mm-hmm. And when I start sparring with people and dealing with like the Mexican trainer, it's going to be very funny.
Mm-hmm.
It's all going to be on Patreon. So maybe don't unsubscribe.
Don't unsubscribe to the Patreon. Patreon.com/hatewatchpodcast. Join us. We have, honestly, I don't know how other people's Patreons are. I think it's a lot of times just episodes and stuff like that, but we give you, if you like our dynamic as a friend group, the strongest friend group in Los Angeles, literally the only friend group in Los Angeles.
I feel like there might be a group of guys that rob banks or something that we don't know about.
They're probably
pretty close.
But yeah,
there hasn't been a harder crew in LA since the team from Heat.
North Hollywood Shootout.
Yeah, those two guys were tighter than us.
Yeah.
But people don't get
muscle relaxants, loading their AK-47s.
They're like, you ready to die, brother? All right, let's fucking lock and load.
In this crew,
let's go shoot down a chopper.
In this crew, you need to be.
And we can do that at any time.
But what separates us?
You need to be able to puke in 5 minutes or less.
Yeah.
What separates us is we live it. We all hang out with each other.
Yo, is that real?
Pretty much
real?
Every day.
Yeah.
We're constantly hanging out. Like, we are all the ultimate friends.
Yeah.
And there's a bunch more that we don't even let on the podcast. But,
the other boys?
There's a couple lost boys.
Huh?
Wait until they meet the bench.
Oh, yeah. You guys haven't even seen the bench players.
It's like when you start Tony Hawk and there's those like mystery guys that you haven't
unlocked. Yeah.
There's like four dudes. Like,
yeah, we haven't even brought Bucky Lasik on yet.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so like fucking we, on the Patreon, there's a lot of in-depth fun things that you know what we're doing that night, like, mm-hmm. I, you know, Joey has been harassing this arcade
that,
and
I
asking them
like
if the
15
if they,
minutes
if it, when he goes
you
when
like that
Joey
oh, God,
on the Patreon
funny.
The video on the Patreon where Joey goes back to the arcade that smells like diarrhea and he asks the guy, he goes can I, he goes, do you mind if I smell? And the guy's like, oh, I guess. Well, and then Joey goes in and he goes, and then he walks around, he sniffs, and then he goes, well done. He goes, well done, actually. It's not here. Not here tonight.
My favorite comment that I've ever seen on the Patreon ever, can't remember his name, but he saw that video, the first one, and he goes, oh, it's a diarrhea audit. It is a diarrhea audit.
Yeah.
We're literally auditing a place for their diarrhea smell.
These people, honestly, like, the people that listen right now, they're actually pretty cool. Like, I actually, like, really...
Oh, the fans are
awesome.
They're really cool people.
I enjoy
them. I really enjoy them. We really honestly
this one fan
appreciate
to send me, hit me up on Instagram, want to send me a fucking t-shirt. And I was like, I don't really feel comfortable giving away my address. One day we'll have like a P.O. box or something.
Just do a P.O. box.
Just give him your address.
Give him your address.
Give him your address. You live with other people. Maybe he'll kill the roommate you hate.
No, I just, you know, he's a good guy.
I hear you.
He's a good guy.
What type of shirt? Was it the Tugget shirt? One guy made a Tugget shirt.
I trust the fans. I trust the fans.
Yeah, I'll give him Joey's address.
One guy made...
No, don't do that.
Did you see this one? One guy made that the shirt where it looked like the Lakers logo, and it
it said Tug It.
It said Tug It, and
time
then it said
to
Time to Die.
That was great. We're gonna have T-shirts soon. We're gonna have T-shirts.
Yeah.
It's gonna be
no,
sick.
Let's not do that.
Not yet. We will at some point, but we have to get to a point where it's not embarrassing.
Like the thicc boys, all of a sudden, it's like this.
Well, we could have
pathetic
cool T-shirts.
I'm just so sickened by
you. Are so anti everything that makes sense.
Joey wants me to just keep fucking.
We're gonna
merchandise his apartment. Joey's afraid.
It's just gross.
How is it gross?
Joey's afraid if I start getting successful, I won't be over at his house every night watching 2 Days in the Valley, hammered.
If you
watching him throw tomatoes at his TV because he's suffering from limerence.
if we get that Manscaped contract,
Joey,
don't be all alone.
I was watching TV at Joey's like a month and a half ago, and we're watching a movie, and he's, you know, drunk, and he gets up.
I'm not
up.
Listening because my vein is popping, and I can't stop looking at it.
It looks amazing.
And I hear a right by my head.
Because I got a fastball
he
on
fucking,
it.
He fastballed a
Randy Johnson over here.
He literally threw a tomato at his own, like, 75-inch TV. Almost broke his TV.
I was in a bad mood that night.
Yeah. The funny thing is, Joey has no groceries at his house. Just keeps tomatoes around.
No, yeah, you don't even have any food. All the
you have
food
no water, is, just tomatoes.
You have, like, I have water.
Chips. You have water now.
I have water bottles. I always have water
You have
bottles.
Water now. I'm sorry. You used to literally for the
last... Sorry.
Rich, you fuck.
Joey looks at me like he wants to kill me.
I'm known for my water bottles.
For about a year.
No, I had Gatorades.
A year and a half.
I had Gatorades that whole time.
I don't think you drank water for a year.
I had Gatorades.
You only drank water that was, like, you know, Riptide Rush flavor.
Yeah, you were on, like, the Idiocracy diet.
His water's flavored like rattlesnake.
By the way, there's nothing wrong. It's like Gatorade is water.
It's full of coloring and weird shit. You have to drink regular water.
It's such a new age otters, fear.
They want to be in water.
Otter, yeah, exactly.
They live in hot water.
What a new age otter
exactly.
fear.
Yeah. Otters are like,
maybe
oh.
You shouldn't just drink.
Diet Coke is like 95% water, bro.
Yeah.
Aren't you getting tired of just blaming everything on an otter move? Everything's an otter move.
Aren't you tired of being a fucking otter? How about that one?
No, you know,
I don't think about it.
I was running.
I would hate to be a disgusting bear like you.
I was running 10 miles a day. I needed the electrolytes. That's why.
Yeah, but you still need water.
No, it's water in there.
Yes, but it's full of coloring and shit that you don't want to just...
What's this coloring?
I'm scared of coloring.
Yeah, what?
Imagine if every time you drank water,
natural,
you were like,
dude.
Let me
put... Yeah. berries they put
Let me put
it.
Some... Yeah, berries. Let me put
they
some blue
of,
number five in this.
They make it out of berries.
They make it out of berries.
You're right, actually. No, it's actually... Because we all know, you know, glacier freeze is a real thing. And so is...
Glaciers are like the healthiest water they make.
Yeah.
It's like if it's frozen.
It's like God made an ice cube.
No, yeah. You're right.
So that doesn't make any sense.
There's no getting through to these dumb bears. What are you
Well, they
do?
Act like they're pinnacles of health, but we can outperform them in any athletic thing ever.
John, you just threw up because you ate too much.
Yeah, John threw up.
I'm going to do it.
Because you can't eat too much. You probably can't even.
Fucking idiot.
I
ate too much as a hero.
John, you also can't throw.
Yeah, you're like man versus food.
But that's not my fault.
John, you can't.
That's not my fault.
I love John. I love John, but he like makes these big claims. Like he's like, I'm like the peak of it. It's fine. I'm like.
This isn't a claim. It's a fact.
I'll beat you athletically. John can't throw.
Let's do the hike.
He can't throw a ball.
I never was taught. Well, my grandfather polio.
Devin,
I wasn't taught how to throw.
I wasn't taught by my grandfather.
Men just, you know how to do it when they're naturally athletic.
He knows how to scratch. He knows how to. He's
but John
a bear.
Knows how to. He knows how to scrap. He's scrappy.
He knows how to stuff his bike. Yeah. To hibernate
exactly
for the winter.
John posts pictures on his Instagram, or like on his story, where it's like he throws like three eggs on top of some like potatoes.
Delicious.
He's like, man, shit.
This is my morning
that
breakfast.
Looks really
like,
good.
I'm a good cook.
He's like,
that looks good.
You think I'm doing that as like a man thing? I'm a good cook.
Athletic man shit.
I'm a good cook. It was creamy coffee.
Three eggs on a potato.
No, Sean's not doing man stuff. He's a good chef.
No, you're insecure about it. You don't cook your dope breakfast like me, dude.
Those are good breakfasts. Sean's a good cook.
You bought breakfast. I know it.
John, I don't buy breakfast.
What'd you make?
I'll eat. I don't eat breakfast. Breakfast is for losers.
You don't even make
the
good
only
food,
meal
dude.
I make is breakfast.
I'm a fucking great cook, Joe.
Devin has never cooked for me.
What?
You've never cooked for me either.
I made you a fucking giant.
What a weird thing to say,
Devin,
publicly. Devin has never cooked for me. I come home. God. There's never roses.
Who made those amazing quarantine meals?
You? I wasn't there, fucko.
I don't remember because I got coronavirus.
He had COVID.
How good was it, though?
I was there. It was really good.
We had brats.
Yeah, John has
we
shot
had
brain.
Fucking sauce.
He cooked a lot. It was very good.
I was cooking. It was
never
cooked. That was lit. We lived the shop bit where we had God, that was the best few weeks
You've
of my
never
fucking
cooked
life.
For me. You never cook for
I'll
me.
I'll cook
ever.
For you today. I'll cook for you
Why
right
don't you
fucking
cook
now.
Dinner for us at Joey's.
Tonight? Joey doesn't have pots and shit.
Let's go back to Joey's.
I'll buy some pots.
We'll buy some pots on the way
what
home.
What time is it?
Target's open until like 11.
I got
you
shit
always
to
had
do.
Shit
you don't
to
have,
do.
I'm really busy wow. last 3 weeks. Oh, I got like three projects.
You don't have anything right. going.
No, we all forgot your Warren Buffett.
I gave Ida.
Yeah,
no,
I gave he's Ida. He's really busy.
He's like, I met a producer at my bar. He's like, he made.
He's busy. We get it, Katzenberg.
He was a PA on Waterworld.
Hey, how many margaritas did you make today?
Listen, success breeds jealousy. All right, I recognize this.
No one's jealousy.
Yeah.
I got stuff to
no,
do.
No, we get
I
it. Yeah, we got. No, you're Jeff Zucker. We get yeah, it. You got a lot
John,
going
John's
on.
John's like, you're all jealous of me, all right? I'm always in pain. I work at a train station. I have to deal with heroin addicts and homeless people all day, and you're just jealous.
John's like, I'm always in pain.
I am. I'm in constant pain. I have constant, like, joint pain and, like, gastrointestinal issues.
I went to Korean barbecue. I threw up my dinner. You're just jealous that you don't stop. Yourself to the point of vomiting.
That I wasn't by choice, Richard. It was a necessity. I didn't want to pay $30.
John has an interesting body.
I'm just jealous.
John's body does. John's body is.
It moves very quickly.
It moves really quick. John's the only person I've ever seen where he'll literally eat like an entire meal and within 20 minutes there's a fully like fleshed out turd. Like that. Like his he just immediately.
Well, I think it's like a daisy chain of like an animal. You know, when the animorphs like goes from a person like cat. It's like food to shit, but just constant like down my body. Of course, you know what I mean? Like this is the constant. So if something gets introduced, the last one comes.
You have
out.
A
There's
hard
like
time.
A time glitch in your.
Yeah.
You know what?
Intestine.
You know my only complaint about John, who's my one of my dearest friends on earth. You know?
What's your complaint?
Your only complaint. Go ahead.
My only complaint.
What? Your only complaint. Go ahead.
He's just not likable. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, what is it?
You have a hard time being just another member of the hangs that we do after the pod and stuff.
No, okay. I'm going to be honest
with you. Never
can
just
be honest with you. I'm going to be honest with you.
This is clearly a complaint that he just cooked up right now.
No, we're getting real. John can't hang at your place. He never can just sit there and hang all night and
have fun. I don't really like Joey's furniture.
He always has to go. He always has to go do some nonsense.
Don't really like looking for parking. Don't really like Joey's furniture.
Oh, really? I do it all the time because I love my pal Joe.
I pick him up all the time. How many hangs do we do?
Yeah, but you don't park.
Where I pick him up and I go take him out.
I'll take him somewhere else.
I look for parking.
Wow. He's trying to throw me under the bus because he's been exposed as a guy that can't hang out with his own friends. You can't hang with your own friends.
All right, so
Joey
listen.
Now gets what I said.
Yeah.
You understood what I was saying. You thought I was lying.
I'm entering
it. Now it makes sense.
It makes sense. John leaves early anytime we have like a big group thing at a bar or something. He never is just along for the ride. He's always got.
He can't be part of the crew and just hang.
He can't just be part of the crew.
Just
he's got
to
go.
Yeah.
He's got to go.
I'm industrious. I got to sleep.
He's got to go do something.
I'm industrious. I got to sleep.
Dude,
I might be the least industrious
out of all of us.
Don't double down. Listen to what we're saying.
No,
take
don't
it
double
in.
Down. Listen.
I'm taking it in. I'm
take
saying
it in.
I'm defending myself.
You're getting
John
defensive.
John never. I've never. I finish a movie. I finish like 30 movies a week with this guy over here, Joey. Joey and I watch.
Listen,
I put
in the time. I put in the time. Richie puts in the time.
We all put in time.
Yep.
You need. You know. You're not clocking in at Chang's.
You're not at
Jiu-jitsu three
You're not
times
clocking
a week.
In at Chang's.
Jiu-jitsu three times a week. I work from 11 to 4 usually.
John's,
nowadays it's Dodger season, so I'm working till like 7.
Yourself.
I work 12 hours a day.
So well, it's Dodger season now.
Well, you wake up earlier than me.
John says it's Dodger season like he plays for the team.
No,
you're a bartender.
It affects my. But the fucking bus picks up right next to my bar.
I'm fucking with you.
God damn. Anyway, so the thing is, I'm busy. I'm just a busy guy. No,
you,
I'm not. I'm not angry. I'm
no, I'm kidding.
I'm what's it called?
Fucking, joke angry. But you,
no. Fucking. What's it? You know the fucking weird. I don't know.
Okay. All right, Baba.
Neurotic.
You overextend yourself, though.
You do.
Yeah, and that's
how. Overextended, overexposed.
That's what's going to give me the big bucks.
You could give yourself more time. You could give yourself more time.
I try to give myself.
To do other things that are
well,
more, maybe
as
more
I,
fruitful
as I've,
for
as
you.
I've gotten old. Well, see, I've been gone for like 2 years.
So
the thing is, I'm different now. I give myself personal time. I'm working on myself. I'm entering my 30s.
Is that true, Devan?
The best
is
shape
he different?
Of my life. I'm
he's
a funny guy.
Slightly different,
but as far
not
as
really,
like
no,
overextending himself, and
I'm always doing something. I got.
Yeah,
no,
how's that
no,
different?
No. That's
but also these last like 3 weeks, these last like 3-4 weeks, I just happen to have a bunch of things happening at the same time, and it fucking sucks.
Okay, I don't even mean that. I mean even in general.
My sister's getting married next weekend. Like, I got
yeah,
well,
well,
to
well, what, to what, you? What are you planning it?
No,
who
I gotta
the fuck
be at
cares?
The fucking wedding.
You,
I don't
you
know.
Show up
in town.
Suit.
I had to get a suit.
You didn't even have to fly
even
for it.
I had to go fucking find a suit from Persians and go to the Mexicans and get it cut. That's crazy.
The slightest bump in the road for John is like climbing a huge mountain.
Yeah.
It's like unbelievable.
Yeah.
I know.
You guys are losers.
Right.
Bunch of losers.
But then he'll cancel the wedding just to show us that like guy who camps out. He'll watch that for hours.
Well, that calms me down.
But then we're hey, let's put on. That's a great. I love that.
Yeah, that's basically what I'm saying.
Watch a movie.
John
He's like,
leaves.
I'm out. I'm going home.
John leaves really fun hangs with us to go home and sit in his bed and shit.
It's been like,
and
there's
watch,
been like there's been like there's, this is what happened. There's been like three situations where Devin's wanted me to hang out, and I've been like, nah, I gotta get some sleep. I got work tomorrow. And then he remembers, and he hinges on to those three times.
Yeah.
That's what happened.
No, John's like, I can't do it tonight, dude. Like, I met somebody at my bar.
It's always something.
I have to meet them to do, like, a poetry reading.
John's always, he's always like, I'm going to get killed by a woman on a yacht tonight. I'm sorry. fucking met, like, a
that's
really
why,
weird
this
person.
Why, this is why you got me here. I got the stories. You know, I'm always doing shit.
Well, we love you, and you'll still have the same amount of stories. You still have the same amount of stories. You already told us we're not going to Chiapas with you.
I mean,
Because we're not going to camp in the jungle with you. I'm not getting fucking shot.
I'm not. I'm not camping.
Explain your idea. Nobody's
in the jungle.
Hey, Devin.
If you go to Mexico,
Joey,
I'll go.
Joey, nobody knows what you guys are talking about. So, John, what do you want to do for your birthday?
I want to go hang. Okay, so like Nigeria was too much, too expensive. I crunched the numbers. Too expensive.
That's everyone's idea of a fun birthday. Nigeria.
Yeah. So it's too expensive. I'm going to Chiapas in Mexico. And I'm going to hang out with the Zapatistas.
Who are
they? Marxist.
Those were the boot salesmen on Reno 911.
Yay!
The Marxists live in the jungle. And they got cool ski masks, you know?
Yes.
No, all right, so you're going to hang out with them.
And then what do you do after that?
I'm gonna
how do you have fun?
After they're done.
Where do we come
how
in?
They
what
live.
Was, what, how do you want us to come in? What was
I
your,
don't
what
care
was your
how they live.
What was the invitation you extended?
I said, if you guys want to come along.
To
hang out in the jungle.
Here's the thing that John is being so annoying about. We desperately want to hang out with him on his birthday and do a fun thing, but in a fun place where we have fun.
Well,
and
this
we're
is
not,
my definition
I
of fun.
Want,
I want to do a thing where
it doesn't
I like
sound
it.
Fun
God,
to have.
I used to do all these crazy things.
What is it? Your sweet 16?
I really don't want.
I'm sorry, 30. It's a big one.
It's a big one. Oh, for my 30th, I'm gonna have red ants crawl in my dick hole in the while I hang right, out with a cartel.
How about this? We'll do both. We'll do both. We'll have like a nice fucking birthday. And we used to do joint birthdays. Remember that shit?
Yeah.
Why don't we do a joint
Mine's
birthday
the
14th, on your birthday?
Yours is the what?
Why don't we do a joint birthday on your birthday? And then me, on my birthday, I'll do jungle shit.
You're going to go alone on your birthday?
No,
like,
you know who's going to come with me?
Who?
Joseph.
Who's that?
Who the fuck is
fucking
that?
Fucking Weed Farm Joseph.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, he stole you down.
The guy who fucking.
No, he's. all right. Cool, but what are you doing?
We're just going to go visit the Zapatistas. He's like an anarchist. It's like a political vacation. I want
to
go learn some
John,
shit.
This is like a real cry for it. Just
yeah,
buy a
so
motorcycle.
It's so sad, dude.
Just
no,
buy a
motorcycle.
Whatever happened to the motorcycle?
Yeah, what happened
aside,
to that?
I'm $200 a month for jiu-jitsu.
Right, right. No, that's
$200 a month for jiu-jitsu. So I started doing jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, of course there's an excuse.
Yeah.
I did something else. Was better for me.
Yeah.
I mean, if I'm going to injure myself, I'm not going to wrap my head around a telephone pole. I might as well do something that helps me.
A lot of excuses.
Old no
I'm being an extremely healthy human being. I'm like being like a very.
You are. You're
being
good.
I feel great.
You look great. You're kicking
I'm tired.
Ass. But that's why we're wondering why you want to possibly go. You know, get eaten alive. Because
I learn every time I go
Mexican
somewhere,
forest.
I learn something, and I haven't done something like that in a long time, and I want to spend my 30th birthday.
Why don't
somewhere
we all just go to like a fun city in Mexico where you
not,
have fun?
Because it's not. We can. Like,
it's a great excuse.
Maybe we'll end up doing that. Maybe we'll find a middle ground. But the thing is, this is what I want to do. I want to go out there and do something that I want to do for my 30th.
Right.
Get raped by villagers.
Weird. It's very strange. Yeah, John's like, hopefully
it's
they.
It's not that strange. I just want to go on it. I've been moving all over the place for like 2 years, and I'm fucking. Let me go do something.
And
fun.
It's time to go to a safe place like Chiapas, Mexico.
We can go Guanajuato.
That was you.
Fun.
You told us Guanajuato's literally the most dangerous place in Mexico.
No, it's the most dangerous state, but the city's fine. We'll be good.
State? What the fuck?
Just they got states down there.
How?
Man.
Wow.
They got states.
I thought it's just Mexico and there's
no,
cities.
No, they got different states. Like Chihuahua's a state.
It is. John, well, they don't carve it out on the map. It just looks
Jalisco's
like it just
a
says
state.
It just says Mexico and there's a city.
Yeah, but that's because
I thought it was like California and like Chiapas.
Look
you know,
up Mexico
like,
state map. Look up all the states in Mexico. It's got a population of like 190 million people. Of course, it's got states. Also, check the population of Mexico. If I get that correct, I'm gonna shoot myself in the face.
This
what was your guess?
190 million.
This right here, this dynamic, this is like how everyone feels about destination.
128 million.
Fuck. Okay.
You fucking idiot.
128 million in right. Mexico.
What? You don't know anything.
I got past 100, though. That was interesting. Anyways, look at Mexican states.
I thought Mexico City had like 50,000
yeah, exactly.
people.
Exactly. Joey thought it had like, it's got a population of like 10 mil.
in the metro.
No, no, it's like over 20, it's like 30 million
people. Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's all the states in Mexico, buddy. They got a bunch of them.
These aren't states. These are cities. Mexico is the state.
Oh, my God.
Go, I mean, it's the country, but it's the state. It's the big.
Exit out of the fucking drink coaster fucking map, you retard.
I didn't even realize that.
Yeah, go to Google and go down to one that's different colors.
I missed it.
Jay, Devin pulls up a map. It's just a coaster someone's trying to sell.
Those are all the states in Mexico.
Ferdinand Magellan over here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So fucking.
Hey, Copernicus.
So these are all states.
Those are all states, buddy.
Sonora. But they never taught us this in school.
Yeah, because they don't need to. Man.
Yeah, right. Because you don't go there for your 30th birthday. To the forest.
I don't know what I'm going
to
do for my 30th birthday, but I'm going to. You know what I know what I'm going to do?
What? What are you?
You're gonna get
I'm
milked.
I'm gonna do me. I hope
God.
I get milked.
I'm gonna do me.
Mexico City is.
I'm gonna do me.
9 million people. Mexico
John's
City.
So fucking awesome.
Oh, I got 10 mil.
You're right. Yeah.
Thanks, Rich.
No problem, man.
The thing is I got like.
We could go to like Cabo or something.
You know, I don't.
Or we could go to like just anywhere in America, and it'd be great. It'd be a great excuse. Like, you know, I don't. You know, none of our girlfriends have to go, and we can all just.
How
have,
much
like,
is
a fun
okay? Okay, this is my
thing.
Last ditch effort. How much is a fucking round trip ticket to Hawaii right now?
$1,200, my guess.
I'd love to go to Hawaii.
$1,200, I'm not doing it if it's over.
I'm gonna guess
if it's over $600,
guess,
I'm not doing it.
Well, what date? It depends on the date.
August, late August.
I'm gonna guess $1,200.
Here's the thing, that's hard to fucking tell your girlfriend that you're just going to Hawaii for
put
fun.
It up on the screen so we can sweat this live. $1,200.
Sweat this live.
Babe, it's
all right,
John's
we're all
30th.
Planning
it's
our
like
vacation.
$484
fuck
to go to Honolulu.
We're going.
For a round
Maui,
trip?
Baby. Maui, baby. Not Honolulu. Maui, baby. Maui. We're going
I don't
Maui.
That.
We're going to get an Airbnb.
If that's
Maui.
Fucking true, I'm going tonight.
Okay, like what is it, August?
August.
Yeah, round trip.
Do like the week of like we gotta have the
this.
Show
four
up there.
Tickets.
Show up there on like
first
the,
class.
Like 2 days before my birthday.
What are you doing,
so 2 days before.
So
the
say
20th.
We go for
Joey. What are
we
you
go
doing?
For read,
what
are you 7 days.
You're full screen. It. Joey's. What is he doing?
I'm trying to read the screen.
I'm trying to help you out, psycho. Relax.
Holy shit. $386 bucks. Round trip United for a week.
Devin, I've been so wrong about every
Airbnb
number that I've said.
Cross going
talk.
To Maui?
Just go to Maui.
Do I need a pass? No, it's a state, right?
It's a state, you fucking idiot.
Hell yeah,
Jesus
good.
Christ.
Well, I don't even know why it is a state. They're all fucking weird. Out. They all, they're,
look
not,
up, look
they're
up.
Not, they're not us.
Look up some Airbnbs. Look up some Airbnbs in Maui.
United.
Yeah.
Unite.
They're not fucking. I don't like how.
This is great podcast content.
I don't think Hawaiians
content.
Even think they're
yes,
up.
It is.
Fine, John.
We'll get
it. We're like 2 hours
you know,
into
I thought
this
the
bitch.
Last episode went a little off the rails at the end, but like the beginning was really good.
Yeah,
I love you guys, though.
You guys.
I'm just kidding around.
Well, I mean, if you guys want to join us in Maui.
Yeah.
Come to Maui
you
with
mean,
us, folks.
You know what we'll be? It's a small island. It's going to be in late August. We're going to be in the big. We're going to be in the I think Maui's the prettiest. We could do Kauai, which is supposed to be the garden island or whatever.
Yeah.
But nobody's on it.
I don't know. I don't know much about Hawaii. I mean, I like.
I think Maui's cool because I think it's got an airport.
I like L&L Hawaiian barbecue.
Let's go to Maui.
Like,
okay,
like,
I'll go.
Like,
I go
it's
to
Pasadena.
I'm going to go to Maui.
What's the difference?
I'm going to go to Maui because also that isn't that where Jurassic Park was filmed? I'm pretty sure.
I don't know.
And okay, we're going to go to Maui, but I'm not going to just do beach shit. I want to do like hiking shit too. We're going to do some hikes.
Okay,
I
want to
go
that's
see the
fine.
Jungle.
Yeah, sure. It's right. Hawaii, though, so the jungle's like easy. It's like nice. It's like some. I feel like Hawaii like doesn't have like.
All right, we'll go upstairs. We'll look up some Airbnbs in Maui.
But don't the locals in Hawaii like hate whites?
I don't give a fuck.
Don't they hate? I saw I'm forgetting
fucking,
Sarah Marshall. They were really mean.
Dude,
to,
I don't
Casey
give a
Siegel.
Shit. I don't give a fuck. What are you guys getting for my birthday? Devin, what do you want for your birthday?
What do I want for my birthday? Yeah. I never know what to tell.
What if I get Devin a hoverboard?
What do I want? What I want for my birthday is like I don't know.
World peace.
I want somebody to. I really just want Kobe back. I just want.
That's
know.
So sad.
Oh, God.
You can't say that, dude.
Anyway, let's move on.
Fuck, that's sad.
What do I? What is actually? I never know what a fun thing I want for my birthday.
You just
clearly not.
Honestly,
Jesus.
I'd love. You know.
Why
I'd,
don't we? Why don't we put our skulls together? We'll do a joint birthday.
The
late
greatest
August. We'll
thing I've
Maui.
Ever wanted to do. Like, I just want to go to like New Orleans with all you guys, like on a train.
Well, I,
for,
have,
like,
have you ever
weeks.
Been to Hawaii?
No, I've never been to
so
Hawaii.
Let's go to let's do we just went to New Orleans.
That sounds
blast.
Cool. I like Hawaii because it has all the like the feeling of all those shitty countries you want to go to, but it's not. It's like Hawaii.
But you can see through the water.
Yeah, you can see through the water, and it's like American.
I'll go to Hawaii on the promise.
I'll go to Hawaii
on a vague promise that later in life you'll go to a shit country.
Because you go through like the jungle, but you don't need all the shots and shit. And there's not like people like dancing around fires. Yeah.
Those stars and stripes are wailing.
I want to swim in
the lagoon. I want to go to Hawaii and I want to have like a punch drunk love moment. I want like to want to call somebody and like the telephone like lights up like when they pick up and it's like a very like
what I want to do in Hawaii is go see one of those like presentations of Hawaiian culture that are extremely offensive.
Oh, they bury
now.
The pig.
That they showed like Mad Men.
A luau.
Yeah. A luau, yeah. But what? Yeah. But there's luaus and then there's like whatever they showed Americans in like the 50s. I want that version.
Yeah.
Where they're really making the Hawaiians dance.
I want to go to Hawaii and join a surf
gang. You
know,
tap dance.
Yeah.
I want to see them tap dance.
I want to see them dance.
I want to go to Hawaii. Face.
And then they're just like, they hate it. And, you know, it's
it'd
like
be fun to
kind
of like, I want to go to Hawaii and like destroy really like a
6-hour flight.
I want to see resentful
Hawaiians.
Easy.
It's easy money. It's like New York. I want to go to Hawaii and like, ocean. I would love to like destroy like a historical like rock or something that they
have.
I
want to do some Jake Paul
not
shit.
Not doing that.
That'd be
Logan Paul shit.
Yeah, superstitious I am.
Yeah. That'd be cool.
Insanely superstitious.
I'd love to go to Hawaii. Like
you
want to
do
land.
Something impulsive.
I want to you know,
buy land and start fracking.
Yeah,
they're like there's no oil on the island.
I'd love to go to Hawaii.
Like deeper.
It'd be fun
deeper.
To like kick some people out of their home, like like Chavez Ravine, like really just like kick people out that have lived there for hundreds of years.
Has anyone ever gone over there to like grow bananas or anything, fruit? You know, let's go over there.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, I don't think anybody's thought of that yet.
I know they grow coffee in Hawaii. A lot of coffee.
Yeah, it's the only state where coffee's grown in the United States.
A lot of Java out there.
Get some good. We'll get those.
I feel
Kona,
like if I'm in
Hawaii, cookies.
Hey, there's no reason to be tired in Hawaii. It's all that Java.
I kind of wanted to go.
They got their morning cup of Joe.
I kind
of
wanted to go and what do you want to do? Spicy, dangerous shit.
I thought you'd hate Hawaii. I thought you would say like Hawaii
is one
like,
of my favorite places on earth. Used to go there all the time as a kid.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Lucky you.
What was your life like?
Nice.
Mr. Big Shot.
I had a good daddy.
Ooh.
I had a great daddy.
Look at you.
Didn't teach you how to throw.
Didn't teach me how to throw. Took me to Hawaii though. Which would you rather have, Devin?
My dad never taught me how to throw either. He fucking had, he's missing like a muscle in his like chest. He's a fucking faggot.
We'll figure something out. But you guys got to sweeten the deal somehow because I'm pretty
sweeten
I'm pretty,
the deal. These look at these play these you know
find
these,
some Airbnbs. Look up some Airbnbs. Let's do this. Maui.
You're such a princess.
This is great.
This
I'm
is all John
princess.
Does. I'm not
you're,
kidding.
You're big. Thing.
It's so fun to look
you're,
up Airbnb.
I'm not kidding. Every time I've ever hung out with John, the night ends. He's like, "All right, so fucking, hey, we're going to Hamburg, Germany. I found the Airbnb." And then like the next day, he'll be like, "Dude, this is
I'm
fucking
too fucking
sick.
Big."
And then a couple days go by, and it's just it's like we never even talked.
No, he's like, "Dude, I can't fucking afford that. I'm trying to save up for a motorcycle.
I would love to go
I'm
to
way
Europe.
Too fucking busy. I can't go. Like, dude, I would love to go to Hamburg.
I'm all over the place. I'm an industrious man."
You don't know what you want,
I don't
girl.
Know what I want, but I know a few things that I want. I'm actively attacking them. Okay? Actively attacking the things I want. Richard.
Get in there. You don't scoot in. Everyone else scoots in but you.
I'm scooting in.
Just break that fucking
I
Sony Soprano thing over your leg.
Don't do that. That would be so terrible.
I'm scooting as much as I can.
God
Joey.
Damn it. Oh, yeah, really? Idiot.
That's what you... Well, scoot in.
I can't. There's a leg.
Pull up the Airbnb so the boys at home can see them.
Oh, these are $237 a night. You get to live
right,
in
how
a...
Many, how many people are we bringing? So we got...
Full
we got
screen that.
$237 a night, and you could live in a flower. That's nice.
Is that a flower? What is that?
I don't,
like
I don't know why they're... This is fine. Who cares?
How many bedrooms,
live?
Baby?
It looks great.
How many
it's
bedrooms,
fine.
Baby?
This
how many
looks
bedrooms?
Great. Oh, this is
great.
How many bedrooms?
We found it.
No, yeah, how many
no,
fucking
yeah.
bedrooms?
We're
are you looking at the right amount of bedrooms?
It's only $2,100 in total for a week.
I would chip in.
Yeah that's, can,
actually
that's
not
that
much
bad for anybody.
Everybody chips in. It's not that much
for four people.
How many bedrooms?
Two bedrooms.
Yeah, no. This is the mistake everyone makes when they get Airbnbs. Oh is that we show
what
up to the Airbnb and there's two beds and there's five dudes going there.
Who cares? There's couches and shit.
No,
you're
I'm
ready.
To, all of us
we're
get
gonna
a
be
bed.
Like hammered every
am
night.
I,
we're not.
You're about to sleep
in
the jungle.
Yeah, you
exactly
idiots. What I was
that's
about
different.
To say.
No, but is it
now
different?
You need a bed.
All of us need a bed.
No, we don't. We're going to be blackout drunk every night. We're not putting on PJs and watching the Wheel of Fortune.
I would have a bed in the jungle. It'd be a hammock, but I'd still have a fucking bed. God, I'm not sleeping on a couch.
You hardcore pussy.
You are such a weirdo, dude.
If I'm vacationing, if I'm relaxing, I got a bed.
What a freak you are. You're a freak.
Am I insane?
No, if it's your birthday, right?
You get the bed. That's both of our birthdays.
Okay, well, so you get a bed. You get a bed for sure. Yeah. The birthday people.
Yeah, hopefully there's not a pee in it for the princess. Jesus Christ.
Very good. Very good.
Good, Richie.
Very good.
All right, look up. Just humor me. Look up five bedrooms. You know.
Five bedrooms? What city is this? Fucking Maui.
This is Maui.
Look up five beds, because some bedrooms
are like two. That was a cheap plane ticket, by the way. I couldn't believe that.
I know, me neither.
The fuck? We should do like a group. We should do a group vacation for all the Reddit followers, too, if you guys can make it.
Yeah. If you guys want to chip in, you have to sleep outside on the beach.
Yeah, do we have any listeners in Hawaii? Hit us up.
You'd have to be a homeless cat if you will.
Look up beds. Look up four beds.
Let's get a little hate watch.
They don't even do it by beds.
You dumb fuck. Yes, they do. Just go to settings.
What fucking house has five beds besides like the embassy?
Vacation homes.
You can find a house. You find
I know. How do I type in?
I want a solid gold toilet seat. It's a fucking four-bedroom house.
You for Saddam Hussein's palace.
It doesn't have beds. You just have four adults. If you type in four adults, God, it doesn't say beds.
You're like a fucking 68-year-old man trying to figure out this shit. Okay, beds, look at no. You go bag. Search, and then you go fucking filters, baby. And then you go to bedrooms. Beds, right here, dipshit. Four. And then you go, show 257 places.
That was so fast and easy.
Good God. There we go, Debbie.
Devin, you just got cucked.
Good God, this fucking moron.
Look at those bear synapses firing.
That was
all
bear
cylinders.
Bear instincts.
This is a rare find.
Yeah. The bear necessities.
That's good. All right, look at this.
This is a rare find, but it's not on the ocean. I want it to be really forgetting Sarah Marshall-y.
You want that one?
I want.
No, look at all these places. Got ocean views. I hate coral, though.
What's this 288?
Fuck coral.
Coral
sucks.
You
ever try to swim around coral? Richard.
What about this condo?
You ever try to swim around coral?
No.
It's the worst. You cut your feet up.
Look at this condo.
Is it on the sea?
It's like very, these beds are not very good.
No fucking coral.
No coral.
Coral is stupid.
No,
coral
I want access to a beach. I want four beds. Jellyfish I want either. No coral. No, there'll be jellyfish. You just got to be careful.
Yeah, I want to be like right on the beach.
I don't want to get stung.
I want to be
guys,
right on the beach.
You guys go fishing?
Yeah, of course. I'll do anything.
I love fishing.
So why? Yeah. I'll do anything. I'll fucking, I want to eat one of those pigs.
All right, bros. We'll get up at fucking 4 a.m.
I went fishing with two.
I want all the women to be like, holy, 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 holy. I want their flowers.
And a pig with an apple in its mouth.
A pig and the apple. Yeah, the pig with the apple.
I got scammed by a man in Mexico who said, I go, I'm looking for a fishing trip. And he goes, do you want girls on the boat? He goes, well, I'll do a big party boat. We went out there. It was two Mexican guys covered in scars. They were both grimacing in pain. They wouldn't look at me, and they continually told me to stop talking, in fact. They drove me deep into the ocean. It got very uncomfortable.
Were they girls?
No. As I'm stepping into the boat, he goes, oh, the fucking girls canceled, bro. He's like, I'm sorry. And I'm like, okay, all right, whatever.
They don't want to be on your scummy fishing boat.
Yeah, and then I thought it was going to be like a yacht. It was like a cartel boat. It was the shitty little...
There's a bunch of coke underneath it.
Yeah. Is this that bad? Look at this. Yeah, this is a condo, but
coke anchored to it.
Look at this window. You look out the window, and it looks like you could kind of walk over to the grass and the ocean, right?
Yeah, I like that. I'll sleep on that. I'll sleep on the grass.
This is...
How much?
$351 a night.
Oh, that's a great deal.
So four ways.
It'd be, only $3,244 for a week.
At $3,000?
No way. That's a lot of money.
$351 per night. That's not that much divided by, four people? It's really not that much.
Well, it's because Airbnb has, like $386 cleaning fee, $401 service fee. Airbnb is
fucking bullshit. So how much is it in total?
$3,244 before taxes. Jesus Christ. I mean, we're not even at $1,000 on Patreon. We're fucking
$800.
God damn this.
Here's the deal, fellas. We're gonna bring the studio to this place.
I would pay that, by the way.
Yeah, we'll record on the beach.
We're gonna bring the studio to this fucking place.
Well, that's gonna be difficult, but I'll do it.
We're gonna have a week in Hawaii.
Oh, by the way, that would pay itself. That would earn itself back instantly. If we did content there,
And we did like tours and like we right, filmed ourselves right, going right. around. We did like a, we edited yeah, the thing well, right. and we're like a vacation show with the podcast team. And
but what would you guys rather see more? Us having a good time in Hawaii or Devan with a gun to his head in the jungles of Mexico? You know what I mean? So if we want to sell content, you know, Devan sitting there, he's crying. They're putting the gun in and out
that
of his mouth.
That never happened. They would recruit
they're
me.
They're making him suck the barrel like a cock.
They would recruit you know? Me. And they'd
no, they wouldn't. They'd
hand me a gun. And
they'd hurt you in
they'd
a
make him recruit run me in and a zigzag
hand,
pattern.
They'd recruit me and they'd hand me a gun and they'd be like you're really cool, but to be like a member of our crew, you have to kill
John.
You have to kill Fat Man.
Gringos,
no. And that would be great content. You could put that on Patreon, you executing me.
Yeah.
In the jungle.
You have to kill Gringo Gordo.
I'm crying, I'm zip tied, I got duct tape over my mouth. They're making a dog eat my balls. yeah, so I mean, what's the best content, guys? Do you want us in safe, fun places? Or do you want us in dangerous?
Tell
scary
us where
places?
You think it would be fun for us to go and like film it and stuff. What the only problem is, see? I wish we had enough
We're
money
doing
to like,
it this
hire
summer.
A guy that films us and does it all. I always have to
we
do
got
everything.
A guy.
Well, no,
we got
first
a guy.
Of all, unleash,
we got a guy.
Unleash me in Mexico. I'll give you the best content ever
Maybe.
Made.
Brian works.
Yeah, but he'll drop.
No, we can find a guy in one of the. If we go to Mexico, we can find a guy that will film us, follow us around, do everything we want for $20 a day.
Yeah, he's gonna drop his box of chiclets and then grab the camera and run after us.
No, I'll have a talk. I know these guys. I know how to talk to them. Trust me. I'll get his ID.
What do you say? This is the thing. I'm like, yes.
What do I say to him?
Yeah. What do you say?
Well, I go, okay, it's nice to meet you. I need somebody that I can trust. And then I spend like a day with him just drinking. I get to know him. I find out where he lives.
Yeah.
And I go, okay, so I'm an American. If something happens here, it's getting reported to you know, your local authorities.
Yeah, the Navy SEALs.
It means war.
Exactly.
It means war.
Yeah.
It means war. Yeah.
Exactly. It's going to be a national incident, okay?
Yeah.
And so once he realizes that, like, I'm not going to let some minor camera theft go, he's suddenly going to go like, okay, it's going to be worth it. And then the final cherry on top is I go, and if you can do this without robbing us or fucking us over, I will give you $1,000 at the end of this.
You give him $1,000?
No. No. But by then, I'm out of the country. He's not allowed in America.
So
he'll never find
him. Oh, no. We're scot free,
so we can go. Yeah,
you get right back to America. You vote Trump 2024. Keep him right out.
The wall just got 6 feet higher.
This could very easily be like we could be like doing like parts unknown stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
doing like safe Maui shit. You know?
Hell yeah,
this we is do great. Both. You know that's the ultimate.
Well,
dream
we wanted
of this podcast.
To be fair, like to let people know like why we're doing this weird thing right now, like talking about this. We've been talking for a while about like our desire to take this show on like the road, like not we want to do live shows at some point, but we don't think we have a big.
You know what
fan
we should do is,
but we really want to do like Insomniac style shit.
Yeah,
that was. But with
we want
just
a group.
And,
yeah, you know us, and we do. Yeah, but
I
you
can't
know what
you
do?
How wildly entertaining New Orleans was.
I mean, John and I could wildly have had our own show. We hung out wildly with tons of different like. Street people.
Crazy shit happened.
Well, let's do a dry run in Little Tokyo in my neighborhood at all the spots that we've talked about.
I say we do a dry run in Maui.
And go to the spots that we've been trolling.
How do we figure out the
dry run Maui
licenses and stuff?
Dry run Maui.
We'll talk to them. Johnny, I'm talking about a dry run where you can just do it very easily.
Dry run is a place. We know that place. It's dry run should be in a place we're totally unfamiliar with.
No, a dry run is a thing where it's a test that you do where there's no risk of failing. Right? So we don't have to spend money. We can just grab our phones, film it. We'll talk to the pit. We'll talk to the other. We'll talk to the diarrhea arcade. We'll talk to the local places and just be like. And by the way, we won't talk to them. We'll just film.
Yeah, I don't think we have to.
We don't have to.
We don't have to have a license. To,
no,
like,
we
film
do.
People?
But we'll just break the rules.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
So we'll just do
like
it and see what happens.
All right, we'll see how
and
it
we'll
goes.
Do our, we'll edit it together, and it's gonna be people. When people see it, they're gonna be like, "I want to see these guys in Mexico or in the jungle."
Yeah.
Or whatever, you know. I'm not going to the jungle.
Yeah.
I'm going to go to a place. I'm going to take you. There's going to be one time when we go to a place where you guys are at significant risk to contract HIV.
We will give you a camera and you will do a
Being
Blair.
In a room with you is a signal for that.
Oh. John, we will give you a camera and you'll do like a Blair Witch project style thing in the jungle. We will be miles away at a bar.
He's going to bring the footage back. It's going to be 600 hours of him jacking off upside down on his own face.
Yeah, like his dick
like Predator.
Is
like the spinal cord hanging from the tree in Predator.
Yeah. I was going to say you're
some Delta Force guys are upside down.
He's like
swatting
mosquitoes.
Yeah. No, yeah, John's upside down. He's treating his dick like Kyle Rittenhouse's AR-15.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Fucking, you know, but yeah, this is the ultimate goals.
Do all of us have a song? Like, have we ever, like, all listened to a song that we all like?
What kind
of
gay shit is that?
Where is that coming from?
I want to be able to.
What are you talking about?
I want to be
able to. You just uttered the gayest
word. Why don't you put your dental dam in before you say that again?
How do we. What do we play when we. When I fuck
put your fucking dental dam.
I mean, no, bitch. Like that. Well, that is the. I'm not even being.
Yeah, I saw it. Was
wait,
it,
hold on. Can
small
we,
town. What was it? Fucking Journey song.
Don't stop believing.
Don't stop believing.
No. Was that our
song? That's end of the
song.
Yeah,
hold on.
Hold on. Hold on.
I love that song.
Pump the brakes, please. Where did that come from? What was behind that?
You're trying to end the podcast with a song.
Yeah.
That's
so. Okay, let's think of it real quick.
No, I will. But why would it be? But it no, probably not.
But let's why? Do it. Okay. What is your pick, Richie? Let's all do a pick.
Well, thick boy John, nation. The only one
that is would work. Like, once we all fail with our picks, we'll go to that.
Oh, see, I was thinking of an like a good song, but the only thing is John's a little bit on the outs on this one. But Schoolboy Q, John Muir would be our.
What are you talking
our
about?
Anthem. What are you
I love John. I love John Muir.
Yeah, I know. But you were at Tuki
Knows. We
you
love
were like
Knows.
In San Diego, and
I don't
Joey
even know what
me
that
and Devin
we were the first Devin. The first time you watched John Muir, Schoolboy. Like I was with you with Mark. I was there.
All right, well then.
Oh, remember Connor?
Now look at Richie trying to distance me from the group.
John Muir actually made
my memories.
Connor
you're
sick.
Not in.
Yeah.
You're not in my memories.
I see what's happening here.
My John Muir memories.
I bet I wasn't. But
you're
I was
also
there.
Not a rap fan. And
I love rap. What are you talking about? Oh, you're a lot of rap.
Oh, I thought it was just an otter thing.
No,
I didn't realize
John never plays.
Right.
Oh, sorry.
I'm not infatuated with
John. Never plays rap.
All right. Yeah, John doesn't like rap.
I listen to Freddie Gibbs all the time. I love Freddie Gibbs.
You don't.
I love Freddie Gibbs.
You listen to him here and
you're
there.
You're just.
I got
you
like.
You listen to Freddie Gibbs and then you go straight to your fucking hang him high fucking songs. You sicko.
Now, how many Freddie Gibbs albums do I have?
Nobody cares about that.
Yeah, well,
you download it.
You don't listen.
You
to
don't
them.
Listen. I mean, you're
I got
listening.
A bunch of Freddie Gibbs.
It would only mean something if you like pulled out a bunch of CDs. All right. You're like, dude, I'm obsessed.
Yeah. Anyway. Look at them gatekeeping hit.
Let's wrap up.
Why drive around with your
Let's
lock.
Show John black
yeah.
culture right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, show
Let's
him
wrap
black culture.
Up on this.
I love this.
What's Freddie Gibbs' nickname?
Freddie Gibbs?
Yeah, what does he call himself?
Big Boss Rabbit or whatever the fuck.
There you go. Very good.
I don't like John's face. It's hurting my feelings.
Is that him?
Yeah, I know you're a fan.
Is that him?
Turn a dollar to a million. Oh, what's happening? Yeah, hey. Orange laces for my shoes.
Good night, folks.
Good night, fuckers.